the smell of the smoke, this place. There are fire in here. No, I'm talking about the entrance. Smell like a place that burned. Good morning, Trinidad and Tobago. Good morning to everybody following us on 104.7 on social media. Big, big shout out to Andy and the crew. Ground report this morning. Lit it up. Start the week hot. And we're going to follow on that trail this morning because while the rest of them making bacchanal and old noise, we want to be raising issues in the public space that gives the power back to the people. And we're going to be talking about issues today that gives the power back to the people. Because the problem with Trinidad and Tobago's politics is the lack of power and authority vested in the hands of the people. We elect governments to office for 5 years and 6 months and have no authority, no redress should they fail or prove incompetent. Governments come to office on a slew of promises. Where in the manifesto for 2015 did the PNM promise to shut PetroTrain down? Where in that? From the moment that became a national issue, from the moment that the PNM started to push that agenda, the people should have had the right to recall that government. Where in the authority of the manifesto, where in those promises, the contract with the people of Trinidad and Tobago, did Keith Rowley tell the people they were going to loot, plunder, and sell TSTT? Where? Where in the manifesto was that? Where in the manifesto was that they were going to shut down the sea bridge, fire the superfast Galatia, cancel the Port Authority of Trinidad and Tobago, take a band of PNM members on tour of the world to buy boats that PNM members and financiers are contract and commission agents for so that they could get kicked back front and back? Where? Where in the manifesto was that? Where in the PNM manifesto was the madness that Sandals became? Because Sandals started off sounding like Tobago has been chosen by Sandals brand, and that was a big selling point. Only to find out, after Afra Raymond had to use every office and authority of state, of law enforcement, of justice, to get for us to be able to read the actual terms of the agreement with Sandals, to realize that the Sandals deal wasn't what it was being sold as. And in fact, it was us just renting the brand. What we were given Sandals was, we were given Sandals the icing and the top level of the cake. We was getting to keep the bottom of the cake and the crumbs, if we're lucky, and we had to pay for all the ingredients, and we had to make that cake happen. And that is the reality of what the PNM tried to do. And Keith Rowley, as Prime Minister, should have been fired at the end of his first year for his manifest failures to govern this country properly. Now, I asked a question this morning, and I asked about recall. Recall is an issue that has to be had, a conversation that we have to have as a country. And when we open the phone lines today, we're going to ask you, do you understand what it means to be able to recall and fire your member of parliament? Do you understand that the authority of the state, the authority of government, the authority of the parliament, the authority of the cabinet must remain the power of the people? That is how it works in a democracy. The truth is, for all our sound and fury, we did not stop Sandals. Sandals decided to pull out. And the frightening thing is, for all of our outrage, if they wanted to still be here, they still would be. Our system of governance is broken. There is no accounting to the people. What Rowley referred to as analysis paralysis is actually called consultation in a democracy. The idea that a government once elected could do as they damn well please for 5 years because they have a mandate is madness. That is why we have to counterbalance elections with recall. The same people who hired you and gave you that mandate should have the ability at any time to take it back if they believe that you are misusing or abusing it. Nowhere in the PNM manifesto of promises for 2015 did they promise to shut down PetroTrend, destroy the sea bridge, foist an unpopular hotel development on the people of Tobago, shut down and sell TSTT, hand out sole select contracts to their friends as if they were theirs alone to give. Nowhere. And again, it makes the point. For all of our outrage at this clearly mad and corrupt government, there is precious little we can do to interrupt their madness, but wait them out. Like we had to do with Kamla and her bandit brigade. We had to wait 5 years and 6 months to fire Kamla. And at that point in time, the only choice to fire Kamla was Keith Rowley. And that felt now, looking back at it, is jumping from the frying pan into the rubbish. And now we realize as a country that neither of those people can be trusted to run this country. There is neither that can be considered lesser evil. They are both ultimately evil. And we have to address that. We have to face that. If you were married to Jim and Jim beat you every day, and you leave Jim and you end up in a relationship with John, and John beat you worse, the solution is not to go back with Jim. The solution is to find a next man or to stay alone. In our situation, the analogy is about government. So you're going to need a government. So you're going to need to find somebody. And every other body that you find, you have a responsibility not to camp, not to settle down and spend the rest of your life with a political organization. Your responsibility is to ensure that who you hire to operate your country is capable of doing it to the best interests of all of the citizens of the land. Because if that does not happen, we will continue to have misery as the main driver of this country. And that is unacceptable, untenable. Without the provision to recall and fire non-performing MPs, the people will forever be left at the mercy of dishonest and rogue governments. The one remedy that puts the power of the Constitution back in the hands of the people is recall. The Progressive Empowerment Party insists that this is the missing link to good governance that would make this country a real and functional one, and proposes it as our first act if elected to office. Nothing is as important than giving the people back a say in what their government does in their name. Nothing. No longer should you have to sit and wait and hope to survive a failed government. You should have the power to recall and fire them. And even if you do not support the Progressive Empowerment Party at this time, you should support the right of recall and insist on it from your party that you support. If there is anything that would keep governments honest, the threat of being fired for misbehavior or incompetence is it. So vote yourself a better nation, where the power of the democracy is once again vested in the voter, where governments have to account to the voter every step of the way and not just at election time. And people say this to themselves, to each other, to the media, to people who come politicking. They say it all the time, that the only time we see our representatives is at election time when they come in for our vote. And the reason is, at that minute of time, you have all the say and they need you then. But you don't have any say after you elect them to office. And that is the problem. That is the absolute problem. Nowhere in the manifesto of 2010 did the UNC, disguised behind other parties as the People's Partnership, because it was the UNC. It was a UNC government, and anybody who was dealing with them. Call Prakash Ramada on the phone today. When he was political leader of the Congress of the People, that was a significant part of the People's Partnership, call Prakash and ask Prakash if what I'm about to say is a lie. Ask Prakash if, as the leader of the most significant partner in the partnership after the UNC, the COP, if he waited 2 years to have a meeting with who was essentially the leader of the coalition of which he was a part. And if you are a partner in a partnership and you can't speak to your partner for 2 years, you are partner in name only. It was a UNC party. And it was a UNC party, and they wanted all their partners to know that. And they wanted to eat. And I told them this earlier, you know. The UNC had this idea from the moment they got power, they went mad. Mad, and they always do that. They do that, get them about 15 minutes after the election results come in, and everybody talk about the voice of God and all the sweet words, and you will hear some jackass on a microphone talk about, it's we time now. Because for the UNC, like it is for the PNM, it is a race battle and a race war. And to them, the real victory is that their race win. And what they do not understand, both the PNM and the UNC, is that tribal war they're fighting in Trinidad and Tobago has destroyed this country. Not just because of their actions, but because of their foolishness. Because they've been distracted playing race war. Because they've been distracted fighting Indian African politics. People who don't look like them, generally, realized that what the Queen and the Crown used to their benefit, that you could divide and rule Trinidad and Tobago and have the Indians and the Africans fight each other like fools in the drain. While they're doing that, while they're distracted, and you could distract them, all you need to do is keep pushing in the national narrative, roti politics and dashiki politics, and that's what they've been doing. They've been doing that for 56 years. And African people and Indian people have been taking that chain up. So the rest of the races have used the opportunity to gut this country. Because we can't account for at least 50%. At best, it could be a lot worse. And I am scared that we get in the government and we start to do the kind of forensic accounting that we need to do to find out how the Trinidad and Tobago move from being the third wealthiest nation in the Western world, potentially one of the most powerful countries on planet Earth, this dot in the sea, financially and economically. We were called a tiger by Time magazine at the end of the 80s. What happened to that money? Because that money should be in a bank account somewhere. If you are not using your money, the bank can't just take your money and give it away to whoever they want. I mean, they shouldn't be allowed to. And maybe it's a foolish analogy for Trinidad, where banks routinely do that. But I'm saying, what should be law? What should be actual law is the money that belongs to the people of Trinidad and Tobago, all of the money that was earned in this country, all of our assets should still be there in our name. We should have massive savings out of the $3 trillion that we earned in the past 56 years. We should have massive savings all across the world. We should have huge assets. Trinidad and Tobago should be a significant investor, partner, shareholder in the Panama Canal, earning interest and dividends. We should be an investor in toll roads in America, in their train and transit system. We could be an investor in Trinidad money, could be an investor in Apple and Samsung. We had that kind of money. We had that kind of money because we would quickly run out of land. After we paved the streets in gold, we'll quickly run out of land to do more fancy stuff on. Dubai had to build land in the sea to do more fancy stuff. They had to make islands in the water to do more fancy stuff. But it's 1.4 million of us. But what happened? Like what happened in St. Joseph when the PNM, or was it the UNC, who created Bangladesh with the Guyanese squatters to give them CARICOM votes? You know that as a CARICOM member, you started living in Trinidad for 2 years and you could vote for our government. You don't want to be a citizen of Trinidad and Tobago. That is the madness of this country. But nowhere in the manifesto of 2010, and the UNC sycophants, I know some of y'all so racist, so stinking racist, you can't get past that racism and see that your racism is poisoning the country that you're living in. You're literally cutting off your nose to spite your face, and you're not seeing that. It is a kind of, it's a level of insipidity that I have never been able to comprehend. how people, I tell there's a rich Syrian community in this country that don't live in Trinidad. They're here, but they're not dealing with Trinidad. They only deal with you over the counter. They're not integrated. And they're quick to talk about a few of us Syrians who are integrated completely into Trinidad. There is a Chinese community in Trinidad and Tobago. And this is before the mad rush of fresh new Chinese came here. That will separate and apart. Fail to integrate. We cannot live and thrive as a nation under one flag if the shareholders, stakeholders, and citizens are divided by race. And we talk plural society. We talk multi-ethnic society. The advertisers gives us this nonsense all the time about the Ganges meeting the Nile in Trinidad and Tobago. In Trinidad, that was a pretty sounding music line for David Rudder. But the Ganges and the Nile don't meet. We have confused Doglas in this country. We confuse them. If you're a Dogla but you're looking more Indian, you have to vote UNC. If you're a Dogla but you're looking more African, you have to vote PNM. It is literal race-driven insanity. And it has broken the country to the point where we are no longer able to have a sensible discussion about governance because all we talk is politics. All we talk is politics, and we talk foolish politics. We talk nonsense, race-driven, tribal, divisive, who thief more, who less worse, who lesser evil politics. So we've never stopped having a political conversation when we're supposed to be having conversations about you are the government. The definition of government, this is an absolute fact. This is, and you see, when Rowley told the nation that the people need to wean themselves off of government, that is the day we were supposed to fire that jackass. Because it showed right there and then that Keith Rowley, 31 years in parliament, 2 years as prime minister, and he did not understand that the purpose of government is to serve the people. That's it. Without that line, we do not need government. The reason for government is to serve the people. You can't wean yourself off of something that is designed to serve you. That's why it exists. Keith Rowley is a fool. And he has demonstrated that you could have a doctorate and be a numbskull. Wean yourself off government. And you know what upset me? So many people in this country consider themselves thinking people. So many people in this country consider themselves intelligent, educated people. So many people in this country have positioned themselves as mind and thought leaders. And not one of them challenged him on that mad statement. It's like telling the people in the back of the maxi, y'all need to find some other way to get where you're going and don't give this maxi driver any instructions. Or just go where we're going. It is insane. The function of government is service of the people. Fitzgerald Hines said, stop coming to the government for streetlights and roads and drains. And jobs. That's a next jackass. It's like a jackass race running inside that cabinet. Fitzgerald Hines. It is the government's job to provide roads and streetlights and drains and jobs. That is the actual government's job. You can't go and apply for a job and when they hire you, tell them, I want the salary. I want the perks, but I ain't doing the actual job. The well-being of each and every citizen is the function and purpose and reason for government. There is a nation state called Trinidad and Tobago. That nation state of 1.4 million souls has agreed with each other that in place of anarchy and violence, we will operate with a user manual called the Constitution of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. And this manual will function as the operating contract by which this nation does business with itself and with others, takes care of its responsibilities. The Constitution of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago is referred to by other names and other terms, but I like the term the Supreme Law. It is the foundation stone. Trinidad and Tobago exists by being spoken into existence on what was the Independence Constitution that was amended as the Republican Constitution when we became a republic in 1976. And the Republican Constitution is pretty much the same Independence Constitution with tweaks that removed the Queen as the head of state and replaced her with the president. Those things are overdue to be addressed. But the president drawing pretty much a salary for nothing is a problem. But of all of our major problems and all of our major constitutional problems that need to be addressed, is the least of them for now. And there are gaps and spaces that we need to address. But I want to come back to this point. The Supreme Law, the Constitution of the Republic, and this is a brief lesson on this, but you need to have this. You need to have this conversation. You need to have this knowledge. You need to have this information. So when people come to talk politics with you, you must understand politics from the ground up. You must understand the base of the foundation of politics. You must understand where all law and all governance in Trinidad and Tobago, where it starts and where it ends. And you must have that information so that you can be able to have an intelligent conversation and not be fooled and led astray. The Supreme Law of Trinidad and Tobago, the Constitution of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, actually, I'm going to quote it when I can pull it up and read it exact. But the Supreme Law and the Constitution of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago begins, and I want you to hear the exact words, right? So I will pull it up, the PDF from Laws of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. And you need to understand what I'm about to say to you. Take it to heart, take it into your soul, go on the Constitution, get a copy of the Constitution, Google it. It is not that big a document, and you don't have to read everything about it, but you should at least read the first part of it so you understand how it pertains and matters to you. The opening of the Constitution after the list of chapters says, the Constitution of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, 1st August 1976. Whereas the people of Trinidad and Tobago have affirmed, another a fancy word for we agree. Whereas the people, that's all of us, of Trinidad and Tobago have affirmed, we agree, that the nation of Trinidad and Tobago is founded. The hard word? This is the word that tells you the authority of the country is you, the people, not the parliament, not the prime minister, not the president, not the police, not the priests and the pundits, you, the people. Whereas the people of Trinidad and Tobago have affirmed that the nation of Trinidad and Tobago is founded upon principles that acknowledge the supremacy of God, faith in fundamental human rights and freedoms, the position of the family in a society of free men and free institutions, the dignity of the human person, and the equal and inalienable rights with which all members of the human family are endowed by their Creator. Inalienable, not subject to be taken away from or given away by the possessor. Understand that. Your rights The reason they use the words inalienable is that nobody else could take those rights from you, and you don't have the authority to give those rights away. They are part of you, like your navel and your earlobe and your wisdom teeth and your little toe. Your inalienable rights cannot be lost. They cannot be taken. They cannot be given. They are you, and they are the way that you exist in the Constitution. So we, the people, 1.4 million of us have met. We're about to form ourselves a country. And we make a list. And we say, okay, we agree, all of us, the owners of this land, we agree that this country will be founded on principles that acknowledge the supremacy of God and faith in fundamental human rights and freedoms, the position of the family in a society of free men and free institutions. You're using the word free? Freely. The dignity of the human person and the equal and inalienable rights with which all members of the human family are endowed by their creator. Whereas the people of Trinidad and Tobago respect the principles of social justice and therefore believe that the operation, don't you hear what I'm saying here now? This is important. This is important. This should be taught in every class, in every school. This is critical information. Whereas the people of Trinidad and Tobago respect the principles of social justice and therefore believe, we collectively believe, that the operation of our economy should result in the material resources of the community, all of us collectively, the people, the country, being so distributed as to subserve the common good. Everybody, we are the common good. And that as long as all of us are taken care of, we are all safe. It is from this paragraph we extract the well-being of each and every citizen is a function and purpose of government. It is enshrined in the Constitution that labor should not be exploited or forced by economic necessity. When you hear a line that labor should not be exploited, that means do not take advantage, do not use economic might and political access to take advantage of people. But worse, or forced by economic necessity, that means do not create a fake recession and cause people to have to operate at meager means to survive on sustenance in a nation that you know is wealthy enough to spend $400 million on a wasteful highway. You have no idea what you're doing to operate the country, and you force people economic necessity to operate in inhumane conditions, and that there should be opportunity for advancement on the basis of recognition of merit, ability, and integrity. Those three words are the operating words of the Progressive Empowerment Party. You could join the PEP today and demonstrate your capacity, your ability, your integrity, and you can rise like the proverbial phoenix to the level of your best accomplishments. You ask around. In 2 years, we just opened our South office. You look, we had our party organizer, Shari Wilson, introduce our South Regional Hub Chairman, Michelle Davis, who introduced 10 constituency caretakers in 2 years. In 2 years, Philip Edward Alexander, the Progressive Empowerment Party, is that organized? Yes. Yes. We that organized. Whereas the people of Trinidad and Tobago have asserted their belief in a democratic society in which all persons may, to the extent of their capacity, play some part in the institutions of the national life and thus develop and maintain due respect for lawfully constituted authority. And what that means more than anything else is that everybody in this country should have a voice and should have a say because of the Constitution. I'm not going to go to read all of the rest of it. I want you to hear those parts. But the reason I read that part, for you to understand, I say it again, the supreme law, and we just demonstrated that the supreme law is the operational law of the country that is Trinidad and Tobago, the nation state, the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. The supreme law that operates it speaks the government into existence. And it speaks the government into existence to do a job that the people want. After the 1.4 million of us met and agreed to operate the country this way, we also agreed it'll be inconvenient for 1.4 million of us to meet regularly. It'll be difficult. Some of us have responsibilities and chores. And instead of having 1.4 million of us gather every time to discuss how we will operate the country, let's agree to send representatives on our behalf to discuss what we want done. So let's agree to break up the country into 41 sections for ease of voting and to make sure that it's not an even number for any vote that is an either or, that we do not end up with a stalemate. If we could divide ourselves into 41 groups, let's give it an arbitrary name. Let's call it constituencies. We'll break up the country into arbitrary constituencies built by a number, 41 of them, so it's generally the same amount of people. The landmass of the constituency might vary, but the amount of votes in the constituency should be the same. And we will break up the country into those 41 constituencies so that each of us in each of those constituencies can elect a representative to speak on our behalf on issues of national importance. So that all 1.4 million of us do not have to gather. It makes it difficult for transport and feeding the crowd. It's impossible to get enough beef pilau with zabuka for 1.4 million people. So let us send 41, one from each constituency. Each constituency, that is 1/41th of the 1.4 million of us that owns this country, that representative now is being sent to meet with the others to discuss the furtherance and the continuance of the operation of the nation state that is the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. They come together to meet and discuss, instructed by us, the 1.4 million people. That we, I want to know that you're following me, okay? I stop right here. We will build them a house specifically for them to meet, all 41 representatives. We will call it the House of Representatives. And the House of Representatives will be a place where the 41 representatives of the constituencies get together on behalf of the people of Trinidad and Tobago and discuss the operation, furtherance, and continuance, the nation state, a nation ruled by law, the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, the supreme law, the Constitution of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. So if we could go forward, and listen, those of you who don't have Facebook to message me, because if you want some clarity on anything that I'm saying, we're going to get into some serious business now, but I need y'all to have this. And I'm thinking that we need to do this regular. Get the people of Trinidad and Tobago to understand. Don't be bored. Get very invested in this. Get very interested. You will stun these mocking pretenders. When they come to knock on your door and ring your doorbell and shake your gate, morning, 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 it's election time, I come to talk. No problem. I here to listen. But I'm going to ask questions. And my questions are going to be based on the fact that I have a clear understanding that the function, purpose, and reason of government is to serve my well-being. So be sure that you can answer critical questions. Let me be elucidated after this encounter that you've done your research, that you know, preferably that you are from among us, in this constituency so that I am clear that you already understand the issues that plague us. Because if you don't have an understanding of what is wrong in this constituency, how can you represent us? More importantly, if you do not have credible solutions to the problems that plague us in this constituency, of what use are you to me? And this conversation this morning is a terrible waste of important time that I could be using to clip my toenails or to clean out the drain in the backyard. Do not come to my gate and waste my time because the Progressive Empowerment Party has empowered me. They've taught me how government is supposed to work and why politics is a means by which I hire the people to go into government to represent me. So make sure you too know that. And I suggest and tell them, listen to Philip Edward Alexander. It's education for free. The House of Representatives will be voted into office. There are different people in each constituency that think they are the best person to go and represent you. Now we have a little conundrum, a quandary, if you may. How do we choose? We could have running races, but that would be unfair to people who don't run fast. We could have wrestling matches, but that will get messy and people will hold grudges. How about we have something like a vote? Call it an election. All of the people in all of the constituencies who would like to represent all of the constituencies should put their name on a piece of paper. Call it a ballot. All of them should put their name on a piece of paper. Make it available to the constituents in the constituency, the people who live in the area, to choose among the couple of them that say, I want to be your representative. I have the best ideas. I have the best track record. I could do it. I could deliver. And let the people decide. At the end of that process, that election, that vote, the numbers are tabulated. And we know that for all of the constituencies of the country, we know that all of them have voted, and that Tobago East and Tobago West and Diego Martin Central and Oropouche East and Couva North and San Fernando West, all of them show up at the house the people built, the house that belongs to the people, the house that we send our 41 representatives to speak on our behalf. They show up there. And the first order of business is to say, we have to operate this country on the issues we agree upon. Let us say that the 41 of us meet in the House, and each constituency, through its representative, stands up and says, these are the issues that are important to us in Diego Martin West. Water, jobs, drainage, security, those are important to us. Every other constituency says what is important to them. Teresa Marquez is asking a question, would that house have recall? Teresa Marquez, that is the exact house that should have recall. And that is where recall should be applied. So to answer your question, not trying to confuse anybody else, what is missing from our system of election and appointment is the ability to fire people. We've chosen Johnny Dhanraj Sabga. And we've sent him to the house. And he's turned out to be worse than incompetent. He is denying a village somewhere of its idiot. And we've acknowledged and accepted responsibility for sending a clown to the house. And we say, hang on. We've sent a jackass into the horse race. We, the people of this constituency, would like to recall him and send a new member. That's how recall works. Back to point. All 41 have made the list of all the things that are important to all the people. So when we tabulate out of that list now a national list, because Mayaro, Toko Manzanilla have stood up and said education important to us, jobs important, water important to us, traffic, transportation, boom. So all of those, and there is a pecking order, the most important one, everybody now interested in water for all, transportation and traffic, crime, jobs, home ownership, education, public health, price of food. There is a list. And that list becomes the agenda of the House of Representatives. This is the people's agenda. This is the purpose of the House of Representatives, to pursue with vigor those issues and to solve them to the best interest in the of the well-being of the citizens of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. That is the purpose of what happens here. The 41 of them say, listen, it is inconceivable, untenable, and maybe even a little unmanageable that all 41 of us meet and discuss all of these things. How about if we do this? From among our ranks, we elect one of us that we could consider a little more authority than the rest of us. We could all vest our support in that person to guide the conversation, because some of us coming from Mayaro, some of us coming from Cedros and Tobago, West and East, and it's difficult for us to get together every single day to have a conversation. So let us get a crew out of us who are capable and functional to govern. Let's call them the government. Out of us, the 41 of us, let us vote again by saying, I support these to operate the country. I support this bunch of people out of us. So the first person that I will give my support to is somebody that I believe, among all of us who are in this House of Representatives, equal. We are equal in stature and authority according to the supreme law of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. Each of us are vested with the authority of 1/41 of the nation state. But we agree, and we have an election, and somebody comes first, and we call that person the prime minister, and somebody comes second, and we call that person the opposition leader. Now that is a stupid and redundant title. It serves no purpose. It creates anarchy where anarchy should not exist, and we will address that. Because the person who comes second shouldn't be the opposition leader. The person who comes second should be the person in charge of the government in waiting. Should you fail to be able to do your job, there should be another organization among the 41 of us who say, listen, I know he can't do it, you know. I could. So I hear. And if he fails, move him, and I'll step up. That's what it should be. Opposing, because Bastio Pandey said the job of the opposition is to oppose. And if ever anybody has ever made a statement that you could consider stupid in the conception part of the statement, you know when you have a thought and then you say it, sometimes you think, maybe I shouldn't have said that out loud. Maybe that was one for my inner voice. Because if the job of the opposition is to oppose, then you serve no purpose to nobody. Because if the government does something that you actually agree with, but you have to oppose because that is the function of the opposition, you're an ass. And they've done that. In my lifetime, Ramesh Lawrence Maraj in government wrote a law that Ramesh Lawrence Maraj in opposition fought against. And the level of stupidity that is by itself cannot be quantified. That you write the law, and then you have to fight against the laws of the opposition. But that is our truth of our condition now. And we have to address that as well. But I think we have to take a break for some ads right now. Not right now. Good. Chairs is just checking up on me. Our situation is now, we have a government. And the government's job, give them the list. This is what the people want. The people want water. They want traffic and transportation management. They want jobs. They want water. They want education, public health, home ownership, affordable food, etc. That's what the people want. And it is the government's job to act that list out. So when Keith Christopher Rowley tells you foolishness, like weed yourself off, God, tell him, Mr. Prime Minister, with all due respect, you're a fool. Because your job is to serve us. That's your job. That's your whole job description. What the people want, what the people desire, lead that agenda in the parliament. We good? You need a headphones to check it? That's what the people desire, and that is your function, your role, and your responsibility. The well-being of the citizens of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago is the function, reason, and purpose for and of government. And if they cannot understand that, they should be fired. Of all the people in this country who should have known that, Keith Christopher Rowley is one of them. He's been in the parliament for 32 years. The House of Representatives, the combination of houses is called the parliament. We've taken that whole from Westminster. We didn't need to, but it was a lazy shortcut. So let's do it. We've been copying and pasting a long time. We have things in this country that serve us no purpose. We have a Senate that serves no purpose. How the Senate is set up, and I could continue into these conversations with you, or we could stick a pen. Because I wanted you to understand how government works while we are on this radio station this morning. I want you to understand on 104.7 today how government works, why government exists, and what is supposed to be the role of the Prime Minister in this country, and why recall is so critical. Recall is the most critical law that we can enact in this country. Because if we could have fired Keith Rowley over the insanity of the mismanagement and incompetence, the rampant corruption the people of this country have seen since 2015. If we could have fired him today by signing a petition, pens would sell out in Trinidad and Tobago. Never has there been a more incompetent buffoon sit in that chair. Never has there been a more vacuous and inane and intellectually bankrupt head of state. Well, he's not the head of state, head of government, as we have right now. Keith Rowley does not know. And he does not know that he does not know. He does not understand how government works. He doesn't understand the job of Prime Minister. All he knows for an absolute certainty is that he's been given some power and some authority in this country in a very manifestly corrupt and broken society. He knows that he has been given the ability to make decisions that he can use to his and benefits, to his benefit and benefit friends and family. So he's doing that, right? Just grab yours and, sorry, just talking to Anthony DeFoe, who is joining us here this morning. So Tony will be clocking in a minute, and I wonder if he's gonna be able to reach his cup from where he left it. I think he's still a little bit asleep. It's a long road. to government. It's a long road to effective government. And that road is going to have to be carved through ignorance. And it's going to have to be paved with knowledge. You, the people of Trinidad and Tobago, have a responsibility to yourself and to this nation to know better and to do better. But I want, and I've said before, I want the most important mission of the Progressive Empowerment Party to be to inform, educate, and empower the people of Trinidad and Tobago. Do you have to press any headphone buttons, Tony? Yeah? Let me say good morning to Anthony Defu. Are you hearing us on your headset?
Yeah, I'm hearing.
Say good morning so we can jump right back in.
Morning, morning. Good morning, Trinidad and Tobago. Yes, yes, yes. We're doing it here for you.
Plenty traffic in from Shaguanas?
Why?
But I was school closed today.
No, it's not actually.
So why they have no traffic coming from Daegu?
There's no traffic coming from Daegu.
There was none. I got into town very early today. Nice. I almost went to play hopscotch. Anyway, I don't know if you were following us.
Yes, yes, and boy, you're hitting the nail so hard on the head.
So you were following us on
yes.
the radio?
Yes, yes, man.
Yeah, keep talking because I want to test this headphone. All right. I know, that's just because it was by the mic for a second. I want to set that headphone up. No, don't worry about that. I will control that volume. Set that headphone up because the people are going to want to call in this morning and talk about, we reach up to the purpose and the function of the Prime Minister of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. And we've explained to people how we end up with a government. We explain to people how it works. People here in my plastic bag, I tried to untangle. We have four headphones. Satish, we need our headphones bag. Yeah, this plastic bag and cutting it. Yeah.
Nah, man, but it's a lot of sense you're talking there because at the end of the day, the people already understand that these 41 people inside this House of Representatives are there for them.
And I want to tell you this, sir. The members of the Progressive Empowerment Party have more knowledge of how government is supposed to work than most of the people sitting in the parliament
in there
today.
Right now. Yes, yeah. You're absolutely correct.
Yeah, and I take great pride in the fact that, and I tell people all the time, that once you're capable of learning, we're capable of teaching.
Yes.
Once you're capable of understanding, we are capable of letting you know what you're supposed to know to get involved in this conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Too much rara, too much bacchanal and noise,
too much old noise.
The fact of the matter is, a lot of this conversation is lost in noise. So people don't know. And the question I wanted to ask today is, and this is an important question. So we were dealing with these issues to get people to the point where they have an understanding. Okay, all these headphones were on full high. So they have an understanding of how government works. But I want to ask a question, right? And do we have any ads or anything around the top of the hour today? Because if not, I want to give you a chance to open the phone lines. And I guess the people who are listening on social media will tell me if they're hearing the callers. We're trying to do our best until the technology evolves that allows us to actually plug this live video. We're opening the phone lines now. But I want Trinidadians to kind of weigh in on this situation. I'll give them a chance to talk, but try not to take more than a minute so that, because you all know, once we open the phone lines on this show,
100
million calls.
Yeah.
So we want to give everybody a chance to call in. Look, the phones light up already. They was waiting. Here what I'm going to say to you, Dwayne. Two things, real important. Limit your contribution to about a minute. And very, very important, I know you want to hear yourself, but put your radio far from your phone. Because when you call in with a lot of noise from the radio, we get feedback here. The questions I'm going to ask Trinidad and Tobago is, do you think that you understand how government is supposed to work? Do you think, as we're on the radio here and you're going to be allowed to call in, Do you think that you understand sufficiently how government is supposed to work and what the role of the voters are in this republic? Because we're going to take some calls on that right now. Yeah. Tony, you could go ahead and you could open those lines. Hello, good morning.
Morning, morning. Yes, man, morning. Sandy Grandi,
good morning. Yes, yes. And also, thank you for that. We want everybody to... That's internal. That's internal. That's not government. That's not constitution. That's like when Nylon Hippolyte went up for Lavantel West in the PNM. And the PNM, 25 out of 27 party groups said they wanted Nylon. It's like when Diego Martin Central chose Amory Brown. And Rowley himself decided Darrell Smith, who he ended up having to fire, whose cousin now is in all kind of bacchanal, who Darrell Smith, who we had to pay for his romping through the secretaries in the ministry. This is the same Rowley who foisted the Fitzgerald Hines, who failed Lavantel East. He foisted him on the people of Lavantel. I just want to give you that information that is, unfortunately, and I don't know how the rest of the parties work. Call her the PNM masquerades as a Democratic Party. The PNM is not a real Democratic Party. They have no democracy in the PNM. To this day, nobody could explain to me how when Manning was fired by the, when he was summoned in the West and fired, how Keith Rowley, who was in the doghouse, he wasn't a deputy political leader. He had no position in the party. Yes. Nobody could explain to me what transpired, what election was held democratic inside the party to make Keith Rowley leader. Because if they had a democratic election at that point in time, Penelope Beckles would have been the leader. Penelope Beckles is a lot more popular in that party.
That
in fact,
right.
If it wasn't for Manning and his foolishness with Louis Leasing, daughter-in-law, Laurel Lizama Leasing, if it wasn't for Patrick Manning and his nonsense, and who left Penelope Beckles out in the cold because he was afraid of the power of that woman. Her absence from the PNM is who allowed Anil Roberts, Lincoln Douglas, and Roger Samuel to win those three seats.
Tell
because
them.
The people in East punished them.
Tell them.
Punish them.
That's
yeah?
right. Yes, man. Very good.
Thank you very much for that.
Caller and Trinidad and Tobago, what we do here is dispensing information, critical information for the population. That is right.
6289595.
Correct. Because listen to me, with information, it allows you to make better decisions, and that's the bottom line.
Logical deduction, critical thinking requires the ability to access information and assimilate it.
This is it.
Thank you very much.
Correct.
No, but you see, that is the purpose of our education system, to dumb our people down and turn them into baton twirlers and KFC box packers. But there is a chance and an opportunity in the country for redemption. It's called the Progressive Empowerment Party, and we're demonstrating our capacity and our ability every single day. So if you... Thanks very much for that call.
Yes,
have a great day. 6289595, 6283131. Punch him in one time. Hello, good morning.
Morning, morning.
Hi, good morning, gentlemen. Good morning.
So far, how are you going yourself?
Good. Well, I can simply say my dad, all my years, I knew him to be super PNM. And every time I hear people talk about, you know, like you said, the rules against it, I don't know what, and it's up. you, and I want to hear people say, PNM not doing this, you are a tribe. UNC not doing this, you are a tribe. You would never hear anybody talk about the role of the government.
Right. Because you had no choice though, caller. Because you really had no choice.
Yeah,
yeah. If the UNC vomit out the COP, that's UNC light.
Right.
If the PNM vomit out the ONR, because that's what the ONR was. The ONR was the upper class of the PNM
teach
when
them,
they were. Robinson takes some of the PNM and went and formed a DSC. These weren't real political parties. When people see the Progressive Empowerment Party and our members and our lineup, listen to them. They are shocked that everyday people could be disintelligent about how government
that
is supposed to
right.
Be.
Does that matter?
Caller, you have a choice now. You can't blame your father, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
You can't blame people who had no choice. We can't blame them. Who we have to blame is ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Now that we have choice, yeah? But caller, we're going to stop on you to take some to play some ads now, and we're coming back at the top of the hour. So stay tuned, yeah?
Yes,
have a great day, my friend. So,
for statements made by the talk show,
so they abandoned me this morning. Talk for 1 hour non-stop. Nothing else I could do. I talk 1 hour straight.
And
we have to get the people to understand these things.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Because we want to expect people to make a critical decision come election time. And a critical decision. When we say critical thinking, what we mean is being able to criticize what you are hearing, not just negatively, to critique it, to be able to say, this makes sense, and it doesn't have to require that it makes sense coming from the mouth of somebody who looks like me, or who have the same last name as me, or who's going to the same mosque, temple, or church as me. It just must come from the mouth of somebody who I think is capable of operating and managing this country so that I could have a better quality of life.
Mm-hmm.
That is what it's for.
Yeah.
We are supposed to vote based on how we could selfishly have a better quality of life. And if the collective not happy, this nation will never be functional. Never.
Now, but your startup great this morning, girl.
Yeah.
Really, really, your startup great this morning.
Oh, gosh. Some of the terms he was using, I was going, oh my God, I'm not there, so I'm trying to focus.
Call, stop us.
Did you hear some of the phrases he used? I thought, oh God. I'm sure we will get out of some comments on that.
Call me. Call me from that call, right? Let me go. Cheers, how much ads they have? Right. Whole place mash up, boy. We mash them up Saturday. I never watch a crowd in a political party meeting have such a time. The people want to go, you know, we'll chase them out there. Go in all the house. Cheers. Our closing song. Could you? We have a closing song. No, vote them out. Could you put that automated in the system? We can find it on YouTube and bring it across. Yeah. Send it to your phone. How do you do that?
Wow. WhatsApp link.
Don't think twice. Janice, organize that with Chess. There will be beaten palm rice conveniently located at Trent's Hoover. Go with him now and sort that out now. Come experience the comfort and ease of shopping from your one-stop full variety. Look out for weekly specials. For further details, call 223-9715. Super quality, never beaten on price. It's Carnival Fever at M104.7 FM. I'm not leaving, that's impossible. You see, we fixed two things on Polkaroo Street. We fix the thing, the pipe, the pavement, and now they deal with the cables on the corner. I tell them this morning on a live video, it's best, the pep had to walk every street in your ass to embarrass them into fixing what they need to fix. And we are back. I nearly knocked myself out my headphones. They're trying it on front ways, like how you're doing it. But on the live, I'm looking like I have a beard. I'm going to do it back how I normally do it. Trinidad and Tobago, we're back inside. I'm here with Anthony, the full deputy political leader of the Progressive Empowerment Party, and my wingman for these morning shows. Give him the proper hello, Mr.
Good morning, Trinidad and Tobago.
You're settling properly. You understand what's going on behind the switchboard, right? Command Central, everything under control. We also have with us PRO of the Progressive Empowerment Party, Janice Lemon Creaky.
Good morning, Trinidad and Tobago.
Yeah, you're hearing yourself, right? Everybody good?
Yourself,
All the same, yeah?
Yes.
Wait, let me see. How about now? Hearing yourself? Hearing yourself at all? That's all right.
Testing 1, 2, 3.
We relocate you. How about now? Better?
Now I'm here. Oh, Lord. Yeah. Now I can hear myself.
Now you can hear yourself.
So, Janice, how are you going here?
6289595 6283131. The people want to call in and talk the talk. All I can talk now. Only joking. Have your say inside of here, but when I switch board lighter, because you know, they want to call in and talk. Listen, one of the issues I want to address today, Tony, and I want to ask this question to Trinidad and Tobago. We spend in this country hundreds of millions of dollars a year operating offices of state who are charged with enforcement, oversight, investigation, prosecution of people who misbehave in public office. For 56 years, not one of those offices have done their jobs.
Mm-hmm.
Where's the justice system, the DPP, the Integrity Commission? Where are all of these offices of state? Where's the fraud squad, the anti-corruption investigation bureau? All of these things, fancy name, fancy title. We've had billions of dollars stolen from this country, and people who operate in those offices are, where are they? Missing in action.
Yeah.
You can't tell me that everything in this nation corrupt. I was thinking, and I had a conversation with somebody yesterday, and I said, at the height of the recession in the 80s, a set of businesses burned down in town for insurance money.
Mm-hmm.
To the point where they shut down an insurance company, Winshaw Insurance. Remember that name?
Yes.
Winshaw Insurance end up out of business. And not one person charged with arson. Not one businessman exposed. We used to be hearing, hey, fire in town again. 3 buildings on fire. 4 buildings on fire.
Yeah.
Where was the chief fire officer? Our arsonist, so good. I tell you, a known arsonist from Trinidad. A known arsonist. And I know when I tell you of what I speak. Went to the States to apply that same trade. Burn one store and spend 7 years in jail.
Look at that.
Is everything broken in this country? Where is the chief fire officer? Where's he? How come we've never had an accounting for that? We are taking your calls on 6289595 6283131. So as long as you're hearing me and you want to have your say, you could call in. Under the People's Partnership Government, we spent $5 million to pull a fire engine that run off the road back on the road. Tony, that fire engine corruption, Jack Warner and the company, I try to remember, I don't want to give the wrong company name, if it was Kusals, I can't remember, Junior Sammy, one of them had get that contract, and they tell the nation that the fire engine went down a ditch, went down a precipice.
Mm-hmm, yes.
So I say, you sure? They say a precipice. I release a video. Okay. I release a video that show that the fire engine had run off the road in a ditch, yeah, not down a precipice. They say, all right, but it required, and they've set a list. 3 days, a crane, rolling logs. If you see the list, I say, you sure you're telling me? They say, yes. I release a next video that show our excavator pull it and drag it up on a trailer. And it gone. No crane, no rolling logs, none of those things. These people lie.
How much?
$5 million.
Watch me. How much did fire engine cost?
$1 million.
look at that.
It would have been more profitable to the state to send old battery buying down the ditch to reclaim that fire engine in parts.
But it's real.
I don't even know if after that $5 million spent, Tony, if that fire engine was ever made roadworthy again, if it was a waste of money. But the fact that from Jack Warner, who made the decision, to the chief fire officer, who said he made the decision, but he didn't understand how the decision was made, to all the people who were involved in that criminally corrupt transaction, not one of them was prosecuted. Not one of them brought to justice.
Not one of them had a question asked.
This is a country that spent $150 million trying to prosecute Ish and Steve.
Never called back. Morning. How are you going, boss? Nice man. You listening?
You will call all of them to do that. Junior Sammy is a billionaire on paving road. All of them to do that. What are you telling yourself? UNC and PRM stink and dirty with that. Your road mashup for the duration of their term in office, 6 months before election, pave it like mad. I tell my father yesterday, I said, watch the science. Eh? Yeah. Watch the science. Put down an inch and a half of pitch on a manifestly broken and disrupted road. Smooth it out, and then that will last a year, maybe two, so that you will get a contract again. We do not repair roads. This is a country. Drive to Wallerfield, drive on the North Coast, drive Shagaramas. The Yankees built those roads in the 40s. In the 40s, you know. 18. We can't build a road in this country that can survive 5 years. Them built roads 70 years ago in this country that stand up still. We are ashamed, boy. Oh God, caller, we're spending $5 billion a year on public health.
Yeah.
Caller, you're fed up, boy. But it's both of them. But PNM people and UNC people, is want to be telling me their teeth less. What is that?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
Yeah.
Thank you, caller. Thanks a lot for that. Have a great day. 6289595 6831 31. This is your morning, Monday morning wake up.
This is your wake up call.
But Tony, we're talking about issues here. Where are the offices of state? The media is owned by the same companies who are financial beneficiaries of all this criminality. So the media ain't gonna be telling you nothing. We ought to do it.
Morning.
Hello, good morning.
Morning, caller.
Yes, caller.
Morning, sir. Morning.
Morning.
How are you?
No bus, no files, eh? What happened in the teenage years stays. What happened in the teenage years stays in the teenage years, all right? All right. Talk your talk.
Island truly and really, but do not care for their own island. I mean, look at the condition of Morocco's beach. I mean, millions of dollars spent in a car park for security guards.
But it's ridiculous. But it's ridiculous. When you pass under these walkovers, they tell you 10.5 million and 10 point... Where's the 10.5 million? You have less than half a million dollars in steel.
Yeah, but Philip, nobody in this island did anything about it.
Because everything corrupt. Every office of state, and that's the question I'm asking this morning. If you go to work this morning and your job is oversight and you not overseeing, you corrupt too, you are part of the problem. Disgusting. After this term though, caller, after this term, two things I want to promise you. They can't say they didn't know, because we rail walking to make sure everybody know. And they can't say they didn't have a choice, because we built them a real and credible choice. Yeah?
Yeah, Philip, I'll tell you something. You have been preaching and on the ground, but most of the stuff that you are reporting on specific issues are not 100%
true. I don't want to tell
you
who you're talking to really, but when it first started, the guys only 6 o'clock to 9 o'clock here on this same station. That's not my guys.
Yeah, well, you know,
you can't give me credit. You can't give me credit for something other people saying.
No. I'm telling you, all what you said about this particular individual was totally incorrect.
Well, then you know what you need to do? What you need to do is you need to provide the factual information. You can do it right now, or you can do it off air. I'm telling you this. At the end... Don't let him talk, Tony. And I want to tell you, you're right for saying that, but I want to tell you this. I have no office of state. Without me talking, stop for a second. People provide me with information, but I want to ask you something. If Philip Edward Alexander stopped talking, nobody talking. That is the most critical and important issue, because I will be wrong from time to time, and I accept that. I have to work with what is given to me. And if you are in a position to challenge something that is said, I am open to that. I am very open to that. But you can't question the work that I do. You can't question that. Because this is a national service. And we have forced change that has benefited you. And you have to acknowledge that. And we will, of course, be wrong. We do not have a budget to do the investigation that I would like to do. But if we get public office, I could guarantee you all of the abusers from Eric Williams to now, who we have to exhume if I have to jail bones, brother. I promise you that. Anytime. 682-2110. Any day. Anytime. And I'm saying this again for everybody to hear. I can only be working with the information that is made available to me. If you see, I always verify, but even that. But again, my friend, and I still don't know. Yeah, but my friend, But again, I want to say this to you. You didn't talk to me as yet, caller. This is the first time that you're talking to me, and I want to tell you this again. Use the opportunity to give me information. I will bring it in the public space. Because if it is something that I said in the public space that you think is wrong, give me fact and I will clear it up. That is my responsibility to my credibility.
Yeah, but
It is important to me that I stand on my integrity at every step of the way. I want to ask you a question. You could imagine what it feels like to be me, working this hard for a country this broken. You know how my name is brutalized, how my character is assassinated hour by hour. There are days I wake up and I think this country is beyond salvation. And I think sometimes to just throw in this towel. When I listen to some of the foolishness that defenders of the criminal, parasitic oligarchy, contract mafia, marauding, plundering, pillaging 1% have done to this country, and they're still talking Afro-Indian politics, I have to tell myself, this have to be a labor of love. I am surrounded by people who tell me every single day. Absolutely agree. Absolutely agree. And this is what I'm saying to you again. I say, Kola, why don't you just forget all of this and talk the truth right here, right now?
Alexander,
why don't you do that? But I want to hear the truth. Talk it now. Thank you, my friend. You see, the problem with critical thinking and logical deduction is it gets lost in translation and everybody think they're capable of it. If you challenge something I say, tell me the truth. You can answer your calls as they come. Hello, good morning.
Morning.
Hi, good day. We had a little meeting in Tunapuna about a year ago, but we have to come back, yeah. And I know that. Right after we opening a north office in Barataria in a couple weeks, and we're going to be walking in your constituency. Yeah, listen, yeah. You have my number. Tony, give him your number. Qualifications in economics. I personally don't have qualifications in economics, but I have an excellent ability of finding the right people to do the right job. What do you need? We will be having all of those conversations coming closer to the election. I'll tell you why. There are a lot of people who want you to expose all your cards so that they could attack you. Absolutely understood. But more importantly than that, you watch the Doctor of Rocks spend 8 hours on national TV and give you nothing. 1 hour this morning, you hear me speak and you could tell the difference between who is educated and understands from who is insipid. Thank you, my friend. Have a lovely day. 628-9595, 628-3131. You could call in and you could talk. Tony, I was trying to explain something just now. Critical thinking requires the switchboard gone again. Anyone you want. Hello, good morning.
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 How are you going, sir?
All I want to find out is that if we have a representative in people and the rural, of a careful payment, a careful payment, we still go pay.
Thank you for that. And Shari Wilson, the party organizer, is also listening off air. And Shari Wilson is charged with the responsibility of making sure that we have representatives of the ground in every constituency. So stay tuned because I am trying to get Shari Wilson to join us on the radio Wednesday coming.
Morning,
hello, good morning.
How are you going, man?
Man. But he wouldn't share it. No, he tell me my information wrong. I tell him, well, give me yours, and he can't give me that. But okay, so if I say the wrong thing, tell me the right thing.
Yeah.
Talk the talk.
No.
And that's why the song we's open with is Talk Your Talk. We's open the microphones and let everybody talk. If you're calling to say I say the wrong thing, set me right. Say, we don't screen calls. We have no way of knowing who calling.
Right.
This show, we pay money to open the phone lines and let everybody talk. Mm. Thanks a lot, caller. Thanks, Toko Sandy. Yeah. Have a good day. 628-9595, 628-3131, and that is a lot of... Anthony Defoe, Deputy Political Leader, and Janice Lemon Creeky PRO.
Good morning. Good morning.
A higher level. Let me go. Let me go.
Mm-hmm. We live in a democracy. Mm-hmm. We have a right to speak out.
Right.
If something is not true, I only touch on this for just a couple of seconds. Restitution should be made, and there are ways to make restitution. I end this possibly segment here. Now, I don't want to get too much into PNM or USC. I want to talk a little bit about governance. Just as dovetail basically what Mr. Alexander was talking about. And that's the biggest problem we have in the country. Yes, the issue with water and education, healthcare and so forth. They are critical issues, important issues. So I just want to say in the light of governance, we must speak out, because those of us who understand history and understand, and I'm only talking about going to the party 20th century, how World War One and World War Two shaped the world through violence and death, but more importantly, what was not present in those circumstances, like, for example, Mr. Alexander, of free press and freedom of speech. That needs to be present. And again, as I said before, if mistakes are made or incorrect information, given restitutions are made. Now, what I want to talk about, basically, is that we need to have a conversation about constitutional reform. The PNN doesn't want to do it.
And caller, when I want to ask you a quick question. Caller, I want to ask you a quick question. Caller, are you listening to me? Cut him off. You're reading from a script there, Tony. Because if you're not hearing me to have a call and respond conversation, we can have it. Yeah? 628-9595, 628-3131. Hello, good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you, my friend. Well, I want to tell you, we're hoping that the next election, those who we would want to see they coming out in yellow vest, they'll just come out in their normal vest and vote properly. That's more important than any protest. You agree? Have a great day, caller. Thanks a lot for your thanks a lot for that. 628-9595, 628-3131. Good morning.
Hello.
Yes, good morning.
Morning.
The saddest thing in this country is every time I reach Roti Cafe, the bodies sell out. And I tired complain. Anyway, what you think is the saddest thing in the country? That has been our experience for the past 56 years. I agree.
Yeah.
And that is why we say we won't take not one recycled politician. Thank you for that caller. 628-9595-628-3131. That's true. That's true. And it has to be said. If you have body on the menu, you have enough body for the whole day. Sharon Sajudin.
Morning.
Hello, good morning. Because, caller, just now, I want to say this there. When you call her, you're hearing me. When you call into the radio show, you can't just go off on a tangent. You have to listen to the people on our side too. In case, all right, okay, no problem at all. All right, so, and you want to talk about the issue of constitutional reform. And that is an issue that we are constantly talking about. But we tell Trinidad Tobago, you can't, they have an African saying, the best way to eat an elephant is one bite at a time. One bite at a time. That's how you eat an elephant. We can't just say we're going to We can't reform the whole constitution at one point in time, but the most important thing that puts the power of the people, puts the power of the parliament back in the hands of the people, is recall. And that's what I took the first hour to explain to the public. Call us, sorry, we have a little technical difficulty. Yeah. We want to actually have a national symposium on reforming the constitution, but it is getting low. It is getting lost in political opportunists using it as a statement without being able to clarify what they mean by that. And we don't want to be on that bandwagon, so we say recall legislation is important. We understand that there are redundancies and under-engineering in the Constitution, and those things could be fixed. Some things require an amendment. The United States of America, they don't reform their Constitution. I had to tell Prakash Ramadan when the People's Partnership was in office, what freed the slaves is an amendment to the Constitution. What gave people the Bill of Rights in America is an amendment to the Constitution. We could amend our Constitution and live. Thank you for accepting that in faith and with love.
Yeah.
But I'm sticking on this issue. If you have a roti shop and you don't have bodhi on your menu, close down. close down. Bodhi is essential to... Good morning.
How are you going, man?
To tell you the truth, I don't think the government know what the government doing.
Exactly.
Right, the youth at Trinidad and Tobago, you're dealing with. Right? And if you want to say, oh, come to help the youth, this is something that we should put first.
Right.
Which one?
And well, am I even putting it in front or behind? Or
tell me, what is he talking about?
The youth care.
Yeah, caller here, what? Take my number, 688-4012. Take my number, call me after the show.
And we will address that, yes? That good enough?
Yes, sir.
Thank
nice
you.
One.
Yes.
688-4012. 4012.
Okay.
Nice one. Morning. How
are
you going, sir?
Tad Bodinet?
Yeah.
It does need a constitution reform.
Oh, God, wait. Talk. Let me hear you.
We're not hearing your call. You can speak up a little bit.
Uh-huh. Yes. And remember, not a person there was paid to be there. This was organic. This was people actually wanting to be there and hear the information.
The reason it is happening is the Progressive Empowerment Party is the sexiest political movement in this country's history. You can't fight that.
Yeah, so true.
The sexiness of the party. All right, I understand that. I was waiting
right.
For somebody to say that.
That's right.
That's why you call her. Go to the head of the class column.
Correct.
Thank you, brother. Thanks for the call.
Yes. Don't worry, we're addressing that. That's number one priority. When take my word, brother. Hear what? You're here for yourself when he was there on Saturday. And again, food production is one of the...
Food independence.
That's right.
Food independence.
That's right.
Absolutely.
Beautiful.
Right after Carnival, we're in a
room. Look out for that in the next couple of weeks.
Have a great day.
Have a good one. I call her.
Bye-bye. 628-9595-628-3131. You are calling the right line to discuss it.
Morning.
Load on your radio. Load on your radio in the background.
Morning.
Call her. Load on your...
Hello?
Yeah.
Oh. You didn't finish? Let me hear you.
Tony,
sorry,
you hang up on him, man. Tony, you're a fellow of integrity and you hang up on the man.
Call her, talk, man.
Call her, talk.
Let me hear the caller. Sorry about that.
You see, it's these long pauses you just do that make people feel you're gone, you know.
Yes,
Can't get away from that. Nah. Stop right there. Nah, I will cut you off now. That's like putting ketchup on our doubles. No. If you're justifying wrongdoing, no, wrong party, wrong show. Cut that call. I'm not taking that. Say you're wrong. Apologize for that. All right, good. Talk your talk now. Alright, but Cole, I want to tell you, the past does not equate the future. What we're building here is the future. And the Progressive Empowerment Party promises you, and I tell you this as a man, that if you put a Progressive Empowerment Party government in office, it will be the first party that you will see that will actually prosecute members of its own government if it engages in foolishness. We have a country to save, and we understand the role we play in the history of this country, you know, because this is the last best hope for our rescue. Yeah, but thanks a lot for your contribution. Have a great day. Cola, what constituency are you based in? What constituency are you based in? Where in Trinidad are you? What constituency? What community? What area? Good. Because I just want to know, because I want to tell you something. The next regional hub office we opening is in Barataria. But this Saturday at noon, we meet in Stanmore Avenue. Come down. You have a contribution to make, and we want to have that conversation with you. Abakola, we had to interrupt you now because I need you to understand other callers want to call in too. Come this Saturday at noon, 19 Stanmore Avenue. Come down and join us. I would like to meet you. Yes? Go to sleep. He's wearing pajamas, but he don't sleep. Have a great day,
yeah,
my friend.
Have a good one, brother.
Yeah. That man remind me of a girlfriend I used to have. They say a woman does have the last say in every argument. Anything a man say after that is the start of a whole new argument. Janice, that's true?
Very true. Very true.
Good morning.
628-9595-6831. Good morning.
How are you going, boss?
Yeah, morning.
Morning.
Young brother. Big him up. Mm-hmm. And that wasn't a nice sight. The man does lie. He doesn't lie, and he know he does lie. He's lie on lying. Keith Rowley, we saying from the start, he have two tongue in his head. $1.1 billion. Don't talk about it. That I sent it to the commissioner of police to investigate. No, but leave that alone. That senior officers in that party. Nobody had senior officers in that party. Caller, everything in Trinidad and Tobago is broken. We watching and we seeing, but we not in the bacchanal business. We want you to put us in office so that we can fix these things. Do you want that? Good. Let's work on that together. Come. Let me just stick on that now. I don't want to give that any mileage. I don't care about those things. Those are irrelevant and unimportant in the national conversation. I know you're trying to make a little joke and thing, and I appreciate that, but I want to tell you. But I said to you, immediately as it happened, and they sent me the video, I forwarded it to the commissioner of police. No, I don't think they sat down in the parliament and debated that. What is more important, caller, is that it was approved for 153 million and it became 1.1 billion. I don't care if you're lucky on radio. I don't care what they're doing in it. What I care about is what we pay for it and who benefited from that money. Because I've passed that edifice every day and it's upset me to my core because there's $1 billion stolen. Where is that money? Okay, after I passed Aruba, I just passed the Kuva Hospital, and that has upset me more. Because that $1 billion could have built 10 hospitals. Yeah. Thanks a lot for your call, caller.
Yeah.
Listen, when they tell you $10 million, I'm telling you, Tony, you in construction business, $10 million to build a walkover. That is not half $1 million in steel. Come now, man.
Tell me
now, how you could spend $10 million to build a blasted walkover?
Yeah.
You don't have $1 million in material. Man. What the other $9 million spending on?
Man.
Whose job it is to oversee and write them checks?
That's
who it, whose job it is to, listen, jail all of them. Good morning.
Morning, caller. How are you going? Janice?
I'm right here.
Wait. He called for Janice?
Yeah.
Caller, this is not the Janice hotline. Where are we going now with
this? I really have my admirers.
We're really telling yourself. Janice.
You're talking to you,
this is not. Let us take off our headphones.
You.
Clearly, this is not our call. Oh my God.
Sorry, say that again.
He's in love with you. Janice have a husband, eh? And he is a very big fella. Oh, good. He said that love will never die. Hola. Wait, no, don't cut him off. Wait. Hola. On the 14th of February is Valentine's Day. I'm expecting to see something nice for Janice.
You see, you putting me in trouble now. You know how much pecan I'm going to get from this guy?
Janice. Hey, answer the call number. We are here to play the fool. Hello, good morning.
Morning, caller.
The Janice hotline. Blessed morning to you, my friend. He's standing long time.
Mm-hmm.
Sharon with him, she ain't leaving him. Absolutely. Oh, come on, caller. He leave room for the mainstream media. They know that is their blasted job. But when you're working for SABGA and SABGA benefiting from government contract, SABGA News Network don't care what Robert Amar is saying. The reporters could do nothing because SABGA News Network not covering it, so good. And for what? And we will remember it for how many days? 5 days? We have to press this to the ballot box. We have to vote these people into oblivion. Thank you for your call, caller. 628-9595, 628-3131. And I'm not letting this issue go. If you open a roti shop and you don't have body on the menu, close down. Close down. A roti without body is not a real roti. Good morning.
Good morning.
I said run a poll.
Thank you.
So
wait, this is now the pips, Janice. Show, call her, talk your talk. A couple women. We have the nicest woman in the party. This party, boy, we outnumbered. We outnumbered, caller. We need more men. They're killing me. We opening our office in Barataria, and right after that, we come in before Easter. You will see us in Arima. We already have the building. We're opening on Tampuna Road, our third national office. On Tampuna Road. Stay tuned. Yes, sir. Politically sexy, we call it. Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you gonna take my job? That's my work. That is my job. Caller, let me tell you something. I know some of them as family, you know. I know some of them that stunting when they go out, the shoes shiny like a donkey stones on a full moon night. The crease on their pants could cut bread. Watch me, and they posing and they stunting and they pretending that they and anyway, let, you see again, my vex. Caller is Monday morning. Come now, don't start the week with this. I vex. I promise you, that is why we're decriminalizing marijuana, to make room. Make room. Make room. Have a good day, caller. Here what I want you to do. Go in the church or the temple or the mosque and pray that the Progressive Empowerment Party see government. We will fix this.
Yes, man. Have a good day, caller. Morning, morning.
Morning.
Hello?
Good well, we know this is not one of Janice morning. And Myra's, but it might be one of Tony and Myra. We need some calls for the fell. Good morning, caller. She thief and she let the people live? You think the government job is to thief and let the people die? No, I don't understand what you're trying to say. I want you to tell me what you think you're trying to say. The government job is not to thief and let the people live. The government job is to serve the people, not to thief. All of them doing that. So don't say this one thiefing, like a different style of thiefing, or a better thiefing. This one give we bygone choker, the next one give we tomato choker. We prefer bygone choker, so we taking this thief. Come now, man. So you're saying that you happy if you getting cough on the left side of your face as long as you're getting KFC after?
Not happy at all.
Well, okay, so now you have a real choice. Let us stop defending the madness of the past. I want your passion in this party. You sound like a good citizen of this country. We can't defend foolishness no more. Call or take Tony's number. Take Tony's number. Write this number down.
688.
What kind of bed are you talking about? A medical bed or just a bed? All right, right. Take Tony's number.
Call my family. Call
take, write this number down.
688-4012.
You have the number?
6888.
Off air. Let's get all the information about your husband and the situation. We will work to see what we can do to help you do, right?
Call me as soon as after the show, right?
Have a great day, caller. Thanks for calling. I sympathize with your situation. Thank you very much for that. And a lot of people, they're choosing, it's like the Baptist, the Shouter Baptist, had to go and sell their soul to Pandey.
Yeah.
So, they, you know, the under the PNM, to be a Shouter Baptist in this country was a crime. You could have made a jail for that.
Imagine.
You had to, the Shouter Baptist, Archbishop Barbara Burke, had to go and sell her soul to Pandey to get a little recognition, to get their religion decriminalized. Here, every creed and race find an equal place. Miss me with that. Come down, man. The phone lines, there are people there.
Morning, morning.
Morning.
How you going?
Morning.
Thank you for that call.
All right, caller.
Cool. I hear that, but you see what? Yeah, but you see what his people saying? What his people saying though is that them living. You see, if you look at it from their perspective, them eating, we can't have that. There is.
Yeah, that call is, me. That's
that,
my
that, that, that hotline.
Call me.
All right, so.
Call me. Caller, you know what? We have to go and do some ads to pay some bills.
But you have the number.
Call me off here, 688-4012. Right? And we go talk and let me see how we can make something happen, right?
That's a good day. So we're going to take a break for some ads. And when we come back, we're going to get back into the conversation. And today, we are going to have a poll. Do you think a proper roti requires bodhi? I want to know. I want to add that to the conversation.
All right.
Yeah?
We're going into a break.
Disclaimer. More FM Limited.
Nadine Jadunat say, why can't we hear what the callers are saying? What's the point? Nadine, you could tune in to 104.7. It's on the wall behind me. That's, this is the best we could do with a live video.
My name is
Dan. I'm
on the
bottom
of the computer speaker.
Yeah.
So we can chat it in.
Get it done properly, yeah.
Intention to discriminate or annoy anyone. We believe it is our constitutional right to free speech, to voice our opinion, and our duty to the population and country to expose the truth.
Right after 12 takes no responsibility for the opinions of others. Yeah.
The calypso just getting worse. It just getting worse. But I go in that party because I like a boy. I go in there.
Oh my goodness.
One. We just got on the phone, right? On the air. Three exceptional guests joining the
queen on stage.
I'm tired like a one-legged man in an ass-kicking competition. My headphones get tied up in these chairs. It is time now for the listeners on this show to start dropping a little basket of fruit and things. Man called to love up Janice me. Valentine. See Valentine Day falling on a Monday or Wednesday. Check and see. I want that box of chocolates for Janice. Man called to I expect him to break out in the lyrics at any minute now. Alright, we're gonna talk a little bit more. We no more we're gonna take a break on the call cell, right?
Yes, I am. But hear what? You're going to have to call me after 12. That's when we get off the air. All right?
Go
all right, then. All right, call me after 12. You too. See press and store and online for more details. Value optical bearing for your eyes. This is a paid political program on M104.7 FM. 1-2, Trinidad, we back. Mr. Alexander.
Mr. Defoe.
Ms. Quickie.
Yes.
Wow.
I'm here.
Let your fans hear you. You're too quiet.
I am right here. Don't worry, I'm listening.
This ain't no Pips and Flirt show. Yeah. Watch me. Stay in all your lane. Stay in all your lane.
Call 628-9595, 628-3131. Call, let us hear what is on your mind.
Tell me this is the best show on radio. He didn't believe. He say he vex. He miss us on Monday. He tune in Tuesday and he ain't find us. He call and he cussed.
Yeah, people call and tell me the same thing.
Monday
too.
And Wednesday.
And the question is like Philip had posted earlier in the show. Do you think you know your rights as a citizen of Trinidad and Tobago? That's the question that was originally posed to the population. Again, you're calling in, just give us insight as to if you think to yourself if you are aware of your rights as a Trinidad and Tobago.
Before you take any more calls, there are some issues that I wanted to put into the public space. And one of them is this. Where are the people who are being paid to provide oversight against abuse in public office. We are those people.
Right.
We are spending money, full staff.
Yeah.
We are spending money on people with big titles. That's they get invited to the
budget,
diplomatic circuit. They go to the clink the glass parties.
Yeah.
But where is any enforcement? Trinidadians live in a country where they hear this one thief and that one thief. He get 100 million.
Yeah.
Boy, that one get 150 billion.
Yeah.
And they're measuring who get more while they're suffering at the bottom.
No investigation taking place.
But Tony,
no
what they don't realize is, and I had to tell my father yesterday, we driving from South, and I tell him, because my mother said that what is upsetting her is the amount of people that vex with me and not talking to her. Because I exposing what they get away with. So I said to my mother, you have to decide. Because I'm not getting into politics to link up with the criminals.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So you have to decide. It is either we're standing for right and decent, or if you want criminals as friends.
Yeah.
Correct.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because we have too many high society criminals in this country who have gotten away with figurative economic murder by corrupting offices of state. Now you have a situation where all of the offices of state that are supposed to provide enforcement, oversight, prosecution, none of them doing their jobs. And the fourth estate, the media, who's supposed to be watching all of them, owned by the people who doing the crime. So the Chamber of Commerce, the Chamber of Commerce itself,
yes,
the media houses, media selling you foolishness as news.
Oh, but look, we had a caller just now. We talk about what free press and the right of free speech. Now, yes, I would say we as a political organization right now is fighting to maintain our free speech, our right to free speech, because the powers that be is trying to do what is necessary, where social media is the only body that we have for a level of exposure where the party is concerned, because mainstream media is blocking everything that the PEP is putting into the public space. Look, we had our second anniversary with the opening of our South office. Tell me, where are the media that is nothing? You can find them on all the TV shows. You can find them on all the morning shows. And why? What information they are putting into the public space that is bringing any type of betterment or scrutiny?
It is a criminal act. It is a criminally unconstitutional act. Nicholas Sabga of Sabga News Network, otherwise known as Guardian Media. They are actually breaking the law.
Yeah.
The Constitution guarantees
the
public.
Free press.
The Constitution guarantees the public the right to political association. But the bandwidth that he is broadcasting CNC3 on belongs to me.
Aye.
It belongs to you.
That's right.
It belongs to the public.
That's right.
And John Prince in the Telecommunications Authority of Trinidad and Tobago is a PNM stooge. And he is not doing his job.
That is right, Trinidad and Tobago. Listen to
Janice,
the information.
I know this.
For you right
I know
now.
I know this hard on Janice. She's a PRO. Every 2x4 party that say they're forming, some of them may even leave the starting blocks and get
correct
media coverage. Yeah.
They get almost a
they
full
get media
page,
coverage.
A full page. And then not only that, when there are critical issues that are happening and they want to get a statement or a comment from the political parties, we're never called upon to give
exactly
a statement.
Because it is propaganda.
Exactly. Right. But
it is manufactured, manipulated, broadcast, published propaganda.
And they are doing that with my license. They are doing that with mine.
There should be a law that disconnects the boardroom from the newsroom.
That is right.
But you know, there are people that say, Philip, look at where all you reach without them. But that's not the point.
Yeah.
It is a criminal act. The Progressive Empowerment Party had its second anniversary, which is an amazing accomplishment.
Well, not just that, but we also took part in the local government elections, in which a lot of the other parties did not take part in.
That's right.
And I think that means that we have really carved a space out for ourselves. But yet, we are still not being given the right of getting out there.
There's a level of nastiness. that pervasive in this country. There's a level of political deceit leading the people astray. Yeah. And as tell him or Ramke soon, so Ashley Alonso is a friend of mine on Facebook, tell me that she, what I say in response to him, she don't give him a wrong for not bringing me on the show. That is not the point. If I am angry that you are not giving my party its exposure that it is entitled to by law, you can't get vexed because I vex, but what the hell is this? That is, you're adding insult to injury now.
Yeah.
You're insulting me. And you see, there are too many people in this country that don't know their rights, that afraid to open their mouth. Half of them talking outside there. Look, your partner, he called to tell me that I was wrong about the issue, but he don't want to tell you who he is or what the issue is or to set me right. I tell him, talk now.
Correct.
I that transparent. I that open.
Correct.
You say I say something wrong. You say what I say, and you tell me what is the truth.
All right, Philip, we had to pay a little bit of bills here again real quick, Trinidad. We'll be right back. Stay tuned.
And if you have any issues with your comment after the show, after 12 o'clock, I can't talk before then.
Right to free speech, to voice our opinion, and our duty to the population and country.
All right, comment after 12 o'clock, and you can talk from me. I'll take all the information and make sure we're going on.
All right.
Trinidad, you're calling. Very good. Very good. You want to know what's happening on the ground? Because we are building out 41 constituencies, and your caretaker will be coming to you very shortly. How much more ads do you have in here? Two more? After this one, two more?
You give this song to check?
Yes.
Put them out?
Yes, I did. I showed it to him on the WhatsApp.
So you think you're going to help play? We need to make some pep ads. Talk to Satish. We're entitled to a certain amount of ads a day. So make those pep ads and let those be running as the ads until they sell ads on the show. Remember to tell people that we are selling ads on the show to pay for the show. So during the show, anybody's interested, because this is one of the biggest shows on radio now. So a lot of people would be interested in getting, because it's real mileage if you advertise on the show. So, yeah.
Well, we could only really advertise during our 3 hours right now.
No,
I will show it to you.
Okay, no problem at all. But that's not what was said, but we will discuss it when we meet you. Nadine Jadunat, you could go on 104.7 or more FM 104.7.com. I think you'll hear both the callers. But on my live video, we are limited by what we can do right now.
Traditional
Well, that is
a paid political program on M104.7 FM.
Yes, Trinidad and Tobago, and we are back. Miss Alexander.
A woman known as the Bikini Hiker, known for scaling mountains and swimwear, has frozen to death.
That's news.
I'd like to say a special good morning to all of the members of the Progressive Empowerment Party and all of the people who supported them in the launch of our South office on Saturday.
Yes.
Y'all did an amazing job. I was beyond impressed. I mean, I am somebody that I micromanage. I can't get out my system, and there was not one thing. Even the blue fringe on the tent, there's not, which is not my first preference, but there was not one thing that I'd have done different. And the level of professionalism shown by everybody, the security, the DJs, the camera people, I mean the camaraderie, the amount of food, boy, oh good.
Yeah,
I eat myself stupid after that. Yeah. I get Macawell syndrome.
Yes.
I eat so much, and then I see other things coming out. I say, boy, Phil, pace yourself.
Yeah,
right? When you had one of those buffet, all you can eat, pace yourself, because the pies was tasting nice. But then I see barbecue wings, Sterling Leha, who is the caretaker for Dago Central. Now that he make them wings. No, but watch.
Yes.
Watch me. Now that he make them wings, he in trouble.
Yeah.
That's
because
right.
He can't get away. The next event we have in Sterling, and I know Sterling is a loyal listener to this show. In fact, I tell Sterling sometime in the very near future, we bring in all the caretakers on the show. And now that we are going to be opening the North office, as Sterling is a caretaker for Digger Martin Central, you'll be hearing more from him. But Sterling, those wings?
Win.
Tony, there was so much food. This is no lie. There was so much food. Tiffany Young, who was coordinating the kitchen, at the end of the event, when we stay and we lime and we eat and thing, there was still so much food. They were wrapping food up and giving people to go home with. I see people leaving with whole cakes.
That's right.
A whole cake. You take your cake and you go, because there was so much.
We had a couple people that had gone to the back, because there was a couple needy families, and we took some extra food over to them.
Oh God, look at that.
Right.
And the coconut sweet bread. I ain't know who make that.
And again, Trinidad and Tobago.
As a fella, I
extend extreme love and thanks
to someone. My entire life is a struggle between wanting a six pack and liking food. I tell it to that plane. Man, that's my life. It's a struggle.
Yeah,
every time I see somebody ripped, Tony, every time I see somebody ripped, I just think about all the food that they didn't eat.
What I would like to say is
don't judge it. This is a girl damn sugar. This is a girl damn sugar.
Well, you see, the sugar I can't have, unfortunately. But
already.
I know, just adding more sugar.
She's too sweet. The doctor tell you, when even your doctor tell you, you're too sweet.
But you see, Janice, I'm big fans of the color of that.
Today's my last day on the show. If I talk in all this talk and what the callers call is the pips, Janice, we're telling yourself.
On a more serious note, I would like to say that I was thoroughly impressed by the amount of food, the generosity of the people that
amazing
brought dishes to that event on Saturday. I have never been to.
But Janice, this is a party
like
where people have donated properties. I mean, they donated use of properties. We now have South. We now have the Barataria office, the Tampuna Road in Arima. We're working right now. We negotiated with the Central. If you have a property or an office facility that you would like to rent us, because these are regional hubs, but we want to open offices in every constituency. We have an office on offer right now in Valencia. If you have an office or a space that you would like to make available to the Progressive Empowerment Party, we appreciate it. You can message me, you can message Felicia Holler, Tony, Janice, but I see some of y'all don't need a reason to be calling Janice.
small business, medium-sized business people, we are looking for sponsorship for the show. If you are interested, you can give me a call at 688-4012.
And Satish, give Satish number out too, because Satish Ramsaran is in charge of that. Satish is kind of handling our advertising right now as we broadening and deepening our push.
That's right.
Because this again is top secret. So when I tell all of this, don't tell nobody else. PEP is going to have on following on this radio show, a TV show, and that will make us king of all media.
That's right.
Because we will be dominating and controlling our own.
That's right.
When I watch CNC3 got 180,000 views on social media, I applauded them with two index fingers, because my page alone got 1.2 million views. So we bombing them on social media, and that is where it matters. We are the 800-pound gorilla in the political conversation. Let them pretend, and I know they still have a little bit of a power and a little bit of authority. The PNM that use CNMG and TTT to their own advantage come into office now and shut it down as a news media. Mm-hmm. So they're trying to hide and pretend that what the wrong that they're doing. But you know what happened? When you see bushfire happening, one of the things you see when you're driving on the highway is dead Zandali all over the highway. Because fire does force Zandali out the hole. When Rowley had to come and do two-part address to the nation, that wasn't enough. When Rowley had to come and pose, where he went live until some panya talk for 2 hours, it's still not enough. He come and do a 3-hour meandering. People at this day are asking, was he drunk or high? I say like he drink the bong water too. Because I listened to some of that. I apologize and I confess. I didn't listen to all because my brain would have escaped through my ear hole and leave and say, I'm not paying up with this. Not even Sharon Rowley want to hear that man talk for 3 hours. And she vow for better or for freaking worse. But that is beyond the call of duty. That is above and beyond the call of duty. That is bordering on spousal abuse. To listen to Keith Rowley talk. I mean, oh gosh, come on, man. Come on. Let's be honest. Let's be honest. All the plot and the plot and stunt that they put him there to talk, none of it add up. None of it makes sense.
And at the end of it all, you still didn't have no solution to the problems.
None of it makes sense. The truth of the matter is, we do not have a prime minister running this country. We do not have a prime minister running this country because Keith Rowley is too stupid to do the job. So other people pulling his strings, making videos, giving him pie charts and graphs that he don't understand.
Yeah.
And that is sad.
Yeah.
We as a nation this morning, we are a ship in rough seas, and the hand on the rudder, incompetent and maybe drunk. We have a problem. Somebody have to say, Captain,
Take
off that hat. Go and lie down in a bed somewhere. We will handle this. Trinidad need a calm hand on the wheel of this country. Trinidad needs people who understand how to sail it. I challenge Keith Rowley and Kamala Prasad Bisesa to a debate on the issues anywhere, anytime. Let us stand up. You want to spend 3 hours, Keith? Let you, me, and Kamala stand up for 3 hours in front of the public.
Yes.
Let them WhatsApp their questions, wherever they ask. Because that will, you see, I want PNM questions and I don't want UNC questions. I want Trinbegonian questions. Okay. Let the people send in questions. Let a computer randomly pick questions and all three of us standing on that stage in the bright glare of the cameras answer. Answer where you know. Because the truth of the matter is they don't know. And the people need to realize that when Kamala come out and say, after Rowley talk his nonsense, she put out what she would have been focused on. More nonsense. More nonsense. They are so disconnected. Tony, they are so, they are so disconnected from the needs of the people. Under the PNM and the UNC, a generation of children was raised to adulthood in the backseat of cars. 3 hours in the morning traffic, 3 hours in the evening traffic. Insanity.
I'm still doing it.
Insanity.
Still doing it.
The price of food in this country is ridiculous. Nobody, and they just come with them. Bullshit, this common tell about a New Yorker has paid $19 for a mango. Because you're a fool. Don't give me your foolishness as an excuse.
That's right.
I want you to tell me, because when you see, I have friends who go abroad, they tell me, boy, Philip, I buy a SUV just for the grocery. When we go in the grocery and the man total and he tell me the bill, I just feel he make a mistake.
Yeah.
I feel like I'll be walking out the door and somebody goes, hey boy, we miscalculated, boy. You owe me our next 200.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He said, I can't believe. And then you know what they're doing me? In the grocery, when I'm shopping, in front of the thing I'm buying, they have a coupon. Rip this off, you'll get it for half price.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, boy. Listen.
Yeah.
What
you can't saying? Help but get fat in America.
That's right.
Food yeah. for soul.
That's mm-hmm. right.
In Trinidad, we losing weight.
Yeah.
It's hard to pay this now.
Oh, you see me right now, boy. My, no. Come, I go on with the weight, boy. Eh? When I go in the grocery, I pull out a 500, say, well, I could get a little something, boy.
Yeah.
You know, it's one bag they give me, and I had to open the bag to make sure, but to make sure to put everything.
And they're charging you for the bag now.
Yeah,
50 cents for the bag.
Understand.
Listen, jobs, hard to get.
Yeah.
The average middle class person in this country is now called the working poor.
Yeah.
They will never be able to own a home. Middle class!
Yeah, yeah.
We fail.
Yeah.
We fail. In 20 years, India moved from the slum of the planet to the largest middle class in the world. There are 650 million middle class people in India. That is more people than America, Canada, Germany, England, Spain, France, Italy, have as people.
You are correct. Last night I talking to some officers, some police officers come out, I believe it's somewhere South Marbella or somewhere there, and explaining to them what they, because they heard you say before, you want police officers to be well paid. You
pay them well.
To be incentives for officers to ensure the job is done and done efficiently.
Pay the police well,
yes.
Pay teachers well.
Yes.
I told you this last week. I said there are two people in this country that I think should be paid well, and one of them is farmers.
Yeah.
People message me and say, who's the second person? Teachers.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
teachers are parents when parents are at work.
Correct.
You want your
correct.
Teachers to be properly paid that they want that job. They want
yeah,
to...
Yeah.
They don't want to lose that job.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
When you... Listen, we overnight senators. The Senate does nothing of value for this country. You have people become a senator today and they're buying tax-free car tomorrow. They're buying a Mercedes-Benz for half price
yeah.
because they're in the Senate.
Yeah.
What did you do to deserve that?
Exactly.
If you say that to teachers and police officers who have an unblemished meritorious career that reach the rank of superintendent or vice principal, I will give you tax-free status commensurate with the Senate.
Ah,
that means
yes.
that a teacher
yes.
now have something to work towards.
Teachers,
not just
Senate.
Not just a watch
oh,
and a pen
oh,
and a card.
Gosh, oh,
I want
gosh.
You, if you become, oh. and listen, to become a superintendent, you need to have a master's in criminology or a doctorate.
Mm-hmm.
To become a vice principal, you have to have a master's or a doctorate in education and child psychology. Listen to what I'm telling you. Eh? If you start to make our schools crucibles of learning, our police officers will not be running down black hen chicken in the road, but will be able to know, and I'm talking about masters in criminology and doctors, they could go and deal with the corrupt SOBs in this society that have ruined this nation. Corruption and greed have destroyed all of the operations of Trinidad and Tobago. Our offices of state are corrupt. No oversight, no prosecution, nothing. Nothing, not one.
Do what the hell
you
can.
You can't name one person who was brought to justice, boy.
Yeah. In
fact, you're doing all you can to ensure the people who are supposed to go in.
No, they just tell you when they just tell you when your teeth legal fees too.
Section
34. And listen to the UNC people who gave me this chain up. Here the new chain up. Volney alone was responsible for Section 34. Now, Volney, now, all you know, I don't like that man. I telling you straight. I never, ever like Herbert Volney. I see him from a mile away. And a nasty, disgusting opportunist. And I know if they investigate him, they're going to find plenty things in his past that I just leave alone because I don't want to interfere with that. But Herbert Volney is not the one who went to President's House on Sunday night on a long weekend to proclaim Section 34. And Kamala Prasad Bisesa has to answer for that. Kamala Prasad Bisesa has to answer for that. And you can't tell me Volney changed the terms of the law after consulting with the DPP because he drinks champagne with Ish in Tobago and come back here and change it. And neither the Prime Minister, the Attorney General, or the Legal Affairs Minister, who is the head of the Legislative Council, who's supposed to approve it.
Mm-hmm.
That means they sign a law unseen, that worse.
Yep.
You are the Prime Minister. You sign a law without knowing who you signing. Yeah. Come on, man. Miss me with that.
Yeah.
You can't excuse this thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Section 34 was a crime and somebody should have made a jail for that.
Yeah.
And I tell in Trinidad and Tobago, the person responsible was the head of government, Kamala Prasad Bisesa.
Yes.
They have no getting away. She and Rowley should be in the same jailhouse. Rowley there for treason with Emailgate and she there for Section 34. But we have never, ever stood up as a people and asked for justice and proper management. Why? Because we want to play Afro-Indo politics. Yeah. We want to play We Time Now. Right. I back in my horse in a race. It looked like me. Mm-hmm. Same hair, texture as mine. That is the nonsense that has ruined this country. And everybody hearing my voice right now know in the heart of hearts, that I am absolutely correct.
That's right.
You are correct.
That's right. We introduced
that nobody
want
to say anything.
Yes, man, to you, no partner. Because you say, go bar and watch me, we go oppose here. But what I say to date, you have hit the nail on the head each and every time. And you had to give Jackie jacket. You have to, and brother. Again, and I would say it in the public space, I take my hat off to you.
Politically sexy.
Well,
all right. You can take some calls. It is 22 minutes past 11 o'clock on today, Monday, 21st of January. Waking up time. We have more ads to run. We run ads at the start. Janice.
And Satish number.
Yeah, again, yes.
Janice, well, you as PRO, you could talk to them about that. Satish Ramsaran is handling our advertising and stuff. But we need your support to keep the show on the air and to help us build the TV show. Progressive Empowerment Party is this country's last best hope at rescuing itself. If you want a better nation, come on board. All of you who know better, who could do things, who are talented in your abilities, come and help us build this. This is your last best chance. Ignore the foolish talk from the sidelines. All those people who are keyboard warriors who dare not stand up, you know. We expose ourselves to the worst kind of victimization, defamation, and character assassination. And we still here. 2 years later, we open our second office in San Fernando.
Right. This is a call for the business community where we are asking for your support in providing, running your ads during our 3 hour long pep talks. And if you are interested, please give Satish a call. His number is 796-8172. The number again, 796-8172. Come and be a part of pep talks and have your ads run during our show.
Yeah,
I was gonna tell Janice Janice, give out a number, but
Don't do that, Janice. You hear what I'm telling you? Don't do that. Don't worry. Give out Satish number and let him.
They go find Janice number. And Janice husband. Janice husband coming. What is this I seen in your phone? What all of this? Top celebrity.
And calls all hours of the night.
628-9595. Look at the switchboard. Give them their talk. 10 minutes. There we go.
Trinidad, give a call.
Hello, good morning. Keep it short, keep it sexy.
Morning, Gola.
Big morning.
How everything? Okay, talk. Not too bad, man.
Oh, God, don't tell me on the air.
Yes,
because then it ain't going to be a secret again. Oh, God, Tony.
Serious, boy?
Strap yourself in and bite down on something hard. Tell me. Call her, I see that girl and she put her skinny as all you say. Thank you.
Yes, man. Are you still up there? Nice, nice.
Ole make a mess of the man, he nearly couldn't get off his bed this morning.
Yeah, boy. You are telling me, I watch me a serious chicken barbecue for dinner.
Nice.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Nice, nice, nice. Nice to beautiful. Have you all, guys. Nice to have you.
Thank yes, you. Man. Thanks
have a great
day. Have a great day.
628-9595-628-3131. This is the real revolution of hearts and minds. Trinidad Tobago, this is the change you never knew you always needed.
Morning, morning.
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 How are you going?
Morning.
Is that a public facility or a private facility?
Private.
And they pay the secretary under the table in a private facility?
Country and went outside to get your issues sorted.
And he's lucky that he had that opportunity
or
that as an option.
Look at that.
Caller, thanks a lot for that. Yeah, thanks a lot for making a contribution. Call Tony off air and we will see what
give
we can do for you.
688-4012
and we'll see what we can do to help him. Yeah?
Right? Okay.
628-9595-628-3131, the Progressive Empowerment Party Pep Talks Mondays and Wednesdays, 9 to noon. We are the number one talk show on radio right now and growing. If you can't find us, change your radio.
Morning, morning, caller.
We can't win a seat. We have three in here. We have spare one.
Call well, where you calling from?
Wait till he's there. Please hang up and dial your number again. That is, all you send hello. Somebody talking
morning,
heads to
morning.
Call them now, man. Them fellas running away with the prize. Good morning. Slack, sir. Janice is a married woman. You slack. It's plenty fellas as be Pepsi now. Have a good day. 628-9595-628-3131. This is the Janice hotline.
Morning, morning, caller. Morning, hello.
Morning.
How are you going?
Good morning.
What is
Good morning.
Are you hearing?
You hearing me?
Yes. I had an incident with the immigration office last week.
Which office?
For the Spain immigration.
In a failed nation, you know what I'm telling you? They have people listening off here that say he reached 6:30 and getting there 7:30. I was there from 3. It nasty, it dirty, it broken, nothing works. The country's a mess, caller. All of that and more. Hey, caller, you are entitled to better. My heart breaks for you on all 1.4. Hey, and that worse, but as. Yeah, but people aren't taking on anything anymore. You know, what you have to do is get your voting finger ready. And as soon as they call that election, cock like Mapapi, we send in somebody everywhere, partner. Yes, all 41 constituencies. He's the ghost who walks. Prakash is the ghost who walks. I don't know what to tell him. Prakash, have an opportunity. He inside the blasted parliament right now. Oh gosh, stand up and have your voice heard, na man. You alone. Anyway, that worse than a political horn. Have a good day, caller. Have a good day. The senior citizens, the elders, listen, man, we're wasting time in this country with these mocking pretenders as government.
Morning, caller.
Making a mockery.
How you going, man?
Good morning.
This Janice husband? Is this Janice husband in waiting? Nasty, stink and dirty. Listen, man, I telling them PNM supporters, buy all your flowers. And. Copy and paste. Thank you for that. Cupcake and puff and juice. A Morbi Media, you're damn right. Vex with them, spit them out. Lies, propaganda. Yeah. But why they can't give Guardian an express away in this country right now? Wasting time. Where you working now? Where you working now? Caller, you see, exactly. And stick up in. We gotta stick up in right there, caller. Yeah. Right. We gonna deal with it. We will deal with it. Thank you for that, caller, Tony. All right. Yeah, all right. Thanks a lot for that caller. Have a good day. We're going to stick a pin there because you're going to run off the reservation if you don't stick that pin now, you know. So right, stick caller. That pin. Thanks a lot for that caller.
Yeah,
ramping up to run off the reservation. Hello, good morning. 628 9595 628 3131.
How are you going, sir?
Mm-hmm.
Your
tutor showed back in the 80s. I was a teacher. Your tutor took me always around the teacher.
A specific roti shop on lunchtime?
Yes, in a mall.
I said roti in a mall? See, I was really at...
Roti shop in a restaurant that somebody could say was running a roti shop.
Yeah, okay, talk to me.
Right, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. Mall roti.
I'm teaching you. Good
job.
Nice. Electronic security.
Right. Thank you. I still don't know, but I if I was eating more roti, then I really needed some educating. Thank you, caller. Thank you, caller. Have a good day. Clarification regarding Wendell Motley's appointment to Sandals Committee dated January 20th, 2019 from the office of the Prime Minister. Now, listen to this crocus bag of nonsense. Eh? In 2016, the Cabinet appointed Mr. Wendell Motley to a committee which was tasked with leading negotiations with Sandals. The government did not enter to the negotiations phase with Sandals, and so the committee was not operationalized. Up to the point of discontinuation of the Sandals project, the preparatory work that had to be done, had to be executed, was done through a special purpose company chaired by Mr. Neil Wilson in Tobago. This work was mainly site and topographical surveys in order to determine where the facilities were intended to be located in order to advance the approval process at the Environmental Management Authority and Town and Country Planning. Unfortunately, even before the completion of these necessary preliminary works from which the definitive answers would have emerged, the brand owners declined any further participation and exposure. It should be noted that Mr. Motley did not get involved in the Sandals project as was originally intended. He, however, was directed to and functioned very effectively as a negotiator on behalf of the people of Trinidad and Tobago on important natural gas negotiation matters. An apology is extended to Mr. Robert Amar, who raised the name of Mr. Motley as being involved in the Sandals project and was told he was incorrect. The Prime Minister apologizes for not clarifying his hearing described. Now, Trinidad and Tobago, to understand, if you've ever not understood what spin sounds like, this bullshit that I just read to you, that is prime ministerial spin. In 2016, the clueless cabinet, the blind leading the blind, appointed Mr. Wendell Motley to a committee that did not exist, that did not function for 3 years. That is a lie. You cannot appoint somebody in a capacity and not pay them. So Mr. Motley was paid. From the moment I receive instruments of my appointment, you are paying me.
That's correct.
You are paying me for this. If you did not operationalize me, as you're saying, I was still there. The job was created. The door was there for me to do the job. If you're saying that there was no discussions with Sandals as yet, you wasted that money paying Mr. Motley and the rest of the people who were tasked with leading the negotiations with Sandals. But you got caught incompetently lying to the public when Robert Amar in the cabinet briefing asked you that. And you said, that's not true. Your people pull you aside and say, boss, you're talking nonsense. You appoint the man. You appoint him. We paying him since 2016.
Now tell me, now that is not just blatant to show how incompetent this
No, man. Wendell Motley was a challenge to Rowley, like Penelope Beckles was a challenge to Rowley, like Amory Brown was a challenge to Rowley. And Wendell Motley, I don't know if he just get tired. So he taking his share. Pay me for this, pay me for that, use my name, no problem. I will operationalize me, do operationalize me. It's all stunting. It's all nonsense. Wendell Motley's a fella I like. I know Wendell's whole family. I know his daughter. I know his granddaughter. Nice people. Nice people. But PNM nonsense is PNM nonsense. If you appoint a man to a committee, he is being paid. The next question Robert Amar needs to ask, and I know Robert Amar is listening to the show, so I'm leaving it to Robert Amar to do. Ask Rowley. Even though he was not operationalized, he was appointed. That means he has a job. Was he paid?
and how much was he paid? Because you can't appoint somebody to a committee, Janice, and not pay them.
That's right. Correct.
They're no friend.
Correct.
Well, you catch yourself after.
Well, maybe it is. Right? Maybe.
But the line that I really like, it should be noted. That is spin speak. And I want you to know, communications is what I do. So I like to read media releases to find what they tried to say, what they didn't say, and what should have been said.
Mm-hmm.
It should be noted that Mr. Mott, so what they're saying is, don't look at that, look at this.
Mm-hmm.
Don't look at the fact that the Prime Minister lied. Look at the fact that Mr. Motley did not get involved in the Sanders project, even though he was hired to do that job. And Robert Amar asked you about that, and you said, now this is the nonsense of the PNM and the copy and paste media not asking questions. You cannot be doing topographical town and country surveys for a project that you are pushing so far forward and the actual negotiations have not started. You are lying to people. You are lying. You are exposed for your deceit, your double tongue deceit. You are lying. You got caught lying here. Because when Robert Amar asked you, was Wendell Motley appointed to chair that committee, the answer was yes. The next question was going to be, what was done? You had to admit. But they are lying here, and they are covering up something here, and we need to find out what exactly that is. What they're trying to cover up. He, however, was directed to and functioned very effectively as a negotiator on behalf of the people of Trinidad and Tobago on important natural gas negotiations matters. We didn't ask you that. I don't care if he looked pretty in his pinstripes, making cake for the kids. I didn't ask you that. I want to know about Sandals scandal. What did this whole bacchanal in Sandals cost us as a country, including now Wendell Motley and that committee? You see where these people, they were saying, what a tangled web we weave when first we conspire to deceive. Keith Rowley does one thing well, lie. He does it every time he speaks. How you know Keith Rowley is lying? His lips are moving. That's the truth. And that is your prime minister. And it's a damnable indictment that you can't trust the man. So if Keith Rowley tell you, walk, run. Run. Nah, they know the song to sing. The song to sing is, you're here lying. That is lying. Every time you read a PNM release, you're here lying. That is lying.
It's just sad. But you know what, Trinidad and Tobago, thank goodness, we have the Progressive Empowerment Party. And again, the party that has been created by the people, for the people, you as a citizen of this twin island. Make it your duty. Come down 19 Stanmore Avenue, 12 noon. Is it 12 noon we're having our meetings?
12.
Yeah, no, 12. Back to 12.
Back to 12. 12 noon, 19 Stanmore Avenue, every Saturday. Come and make
starting it. This Saturday, we are having two meet and greet sessions. Simultaneously, while we are meeting in Stanmore Avenue, there will be a meeting taking place at the Pep South office,
yes.
137 Manahambre Road. So check that out.
Yes, yes, yes.
Two public meetings, yes, at the same time, yes, every Saturday. When we open the North Hub, it'll be 3. When we open the East Hub, it'll be 4. And nobody will know at which of those meetings Philip Edward Alexander will be dropping in on.
Yes.
But I would like to tell Trinidad and Tobago, there will come a time when every Saturday, every region of Trinidad and Tobago would be open for you to come and meet and have conversations with the leadership of this party, including your caretakers and shadow MPs, establishing relationships and getting ready for elections.
You hear, yeah, that, Trinidad and Tobago? You're listening? Oh, I hope all you're listening. listen very, very carefully, because again, this, all of this that is being done right now is for the citizens of Trinidad and Tobago. That's all we see. And again, don't take our word for it. We on radio, yes. We send out information, yes. But we insist you as a citizen come down to the offices, whether it be at the head office on Stanmore or at present the South office, and when the other offices open for that matter, make it a point on Saturday 12 noon where we have the public meetings in your respective constituencies. Make it a point and go listen, understand, ask the questions where your curiosity lies, wanting to know more, know your rights as a citizen, and that is your reality, that is your right. That is your right, and that is what will allow you to make better decisions.
Not only is it your right, it is your responsibility in a democracy
to
know what is going on. You have a responsibility, an obligation to yourself.
Correct. 56 years is long enough, man. Long enough. We've said that we've had independence, but we really, truly have not had independence with the people of this country. And what we are saying is with a Progressive Empowerment Party, mark my words, and I will continue saying it, we are now going to celebrate an independent country, one seeking its betterment of its citizens and forging for a forceful nation.
It is getting harder and harder for the sycophants and trolls remaining behind with the PNM and the UNC to defend the track record of those two failed, corrupt and divisive tribal cancers.
Yes.
The truth of the matter is the PNM and the UNC have failed this country miserably. To compare their track record one against the other to say which is the lesser evil or which teethless, I don't want to hear that nonsense. I want you to vote both of them into the dustbin of our political history. It is time to rid ourselves. What they say, black disinfectant and bleach. We must scrub down this country. We must remove any memory of the legacy of these two failed political ideologies. This concept that we could get away with theft at governmental level of these kinds of volumes is insanity. We have to be ready as a country to take this country back from the insanity of the PNM and the UNC.
Yes, we'll be right back, Trinidad. We're going to pay some bills there real quick before we close up shop. Stay tuned.
Disclaimer, More FM Limited, its owners and associates, accepts no responsibility for statements made by the talk show host or their guests. More FM Limited does not endorse any of the information provided during this commercially booked segment as the truth. That you have to judge for yourself. We, however, reserve the right to question statements made, but in this time of misinformation, government control,
I have the rest of it. You can take it off. You can take it off. Hand it to me. I have the rest of it that you can make it longer. It's just so much things to move on.
But
walk,
no, it's not that too long. It's because of the weight. It doesn't stand.
I know, but what I'm saying is, this comes off here, and you have a piece that you extend here, and then it's just a normal plug. I have that in the back. We have Talk Your Talk today. We're starting it today.
Song?
Song? Not Talk Your Talk. Out. Go them out.
And I have a booster, so battery, so I will be able to stay for a while.
That's your news, real. Oh, you going in with your link?
Yeah. Okay. Naya Black Bondo. She can't sing, but she's nice to look at.
Put on too much weight.
Auto-tune. That is auto-tune.
Yeah.
Put on too much
all
weight.
Of them is...
You hear how it's a natural voice.
You find she put on too weight? Too much weight?
Yeah,
I like a chunksy woman.
Really now.
Auto-tune killing carnival. But Michelle get a doctorate of who? So who is she? Who is she? Soca is a joke. Everything in this country is a joke. We don't take nothing serious. You see the show where they send me a video of people and they say, but somebody says a different party, they lie. But they send me a picture, people take off all their clothes in the fat and wine. You know,
yes.
Keep it
on there.
Huh?
Keep it on
there.
Wait.
What's
that?
GPA
complex.
Is that
what
you have?
Yeah.
You
lie.
Don't get excited.
Tony said we're going in the wrong bed. Your slackness. Your slackness.
Of
course, it's still on.
Oh, I'm not a scatter. Do not believe. Do not believe it.
Are you?
Oh, God.
Yeah, we need some pep jackets now.
I think so.
Yes man.
Yes.
Satish. Where's Satish? Call him. The minister of t-shirt and...
No jackets.
No. Extend his portfolio. Them saying down home watching me live and eating. Man suffering it out of here. Freezing. Eh? Deliver all ham sandwich to the Kruna man. It's 3 hours, you know.
Rip something.
All you ungrateful. What do they say ungratefulness next to witchcraft? I didn't know what that means. Satish, Janice freezing. If she only say that in the mic, people will they come in here with
winter clothes.
How much are this section on, bro?
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes, Trinidad and Tobago, we're back. Last few minutes of the hour, and I don't think we're going to be taking any more calls right now.
No. All your well talk, all your talk today. I'm taking it for granted, man.
You know, but again, I want to send a lot of love and thanks to South that you know, extended such.
That was a lovely event.
Yeah, I agree. That gave me the inspiration to know that this movement is growing, and you know, the people waking up, man, they're picking sense of the nonsense that has been fed to them for donkey years. And right now, like I say, watchmen, don't even take we word for Trinidad and Tobago. All you come down to the head office, go with people in South, all you go to the South Hub office on 127 Manhambry Road, meet your constituency caretakers, your shadow MPs, the people who are there seeking interest for you as a citizen. End that story. And again, we are not in office. Look, we had flood, and we mobilize our people and help families across the nation. Again, Trinidad and Tobago, the Progressive Empowerment Party, is not in office, and we are doing what we can within our own capacity and even beyond to try to pacify.
Tony, I need to read something, and it's important.
Go ahead.
Patricia Mendez posted this 11 hours ago. Attacked at Foreshore Lights. I don't usually post to Facebook, but something very unfortunate happened to me and my family today, and I need to let people know the kind of monsters we're dealing with out here. At approximately 5:30 p.m., that's in the height of the afternoon, my family and I were heading west along the foreshore and stopped at the lights. My husband was driving, I was in the passenger seat, my daughter, mom, and sister in the back. Out of nowhere, a man comes up to my door and hits me with an object. I didn't even see him approach, I just heard the lash and felt the blow. Then there was blood everywhere. My husband yelled out. The man attempted to get out the car and the man ran off. He realized I was hurt and didn't know where the bleeding was coming from. I just told him to drive straight to the hospital. My daughter in the back is crying, mommy, what happened to mommy? Is screaming, and I just in shock trying to figure out what just happened and why. I tried dial 999, I didn't get through. Thankfully a police was in the hospital and made a call. They said they went out but didn't see anyone. There were vehicles behind. I know someone must have seen something. Please, if you witness, call the St. James Police Station. Both my top and bottom lips was busted. My tooth is broken. I got cut on my neck. What the hell is going on in this country? What is going on? If you saw something, anybody in Trinidad, if you saw something, and you know what it was, it had to be some kind of bad drive situation again, you know. We've gone mad as a nation. The people feel unrepresented. A lot of these crimes that are happening behind between people are crimes of frustration and anger. Nobody waking up in Trinidad happy.
Correct.
The reason? That's why we want to be drunk all the time.
All the time.
You want to be numb, want to be high, because you don't want to be tolerating and even thinking of the situation you're living in as a citizen in this place. Say, now 2 or 3 hours in traffic, having to deal with all the issues you're dealing with.
Your job is a mess. You can't risk speaking out, because if you get fired, you can't get a next job. Madness. People taking advantage of you. The people in the law enforcement, the security guards. Security guards, when they tell you that they're not getting the treatment they're supposed to be getting, they're not getting paid like they're supposed to be getting paid, we're taking advantage. Venezuelans, Nigerians, Chinese people, we in Trinidad Tobago have become a mockery. We need to fix this. We are losing the plot. This country has become something that people just feeling to flee from.
Because there's nothing to stay for.
They're giving us all this nonsense about sexiest accent, happiest people, foolish talk.
What are we saying?
Half past five on the foreshore, you get your face, boss.
Yeah. Just so. And you going about your business, just so. That is what you had a deal with. And you hear the woman with your husband and child in car. Supposedly your husband wasn't there. And it was she and the child alone. What was this woman predicament? What was she situation in reality? Yeah? And this is what our citizens are going to be dealing with on a day-to-day.
The truth of the matter of this situation is Trinidad and Tobago is broken by deliberate design. Michelle Davis, the head of the South Hub, coined the phrase deliberate incompetency. I say it's worse than incompetency. This is actual, factual act planned. This is designed to create opportunities for friends and feed, need for water, need for leadership, need for food, need for housing. The entire population of this country reeling. People just holding their corner.
Yeah.
Nobody happy.
Nobody's happy.
And for the smallest things, the people fighting each other. We do not have governance. We do not have leadership. We've not had governance for a long time. What we're doing is we're rewriting history to fit the facts. We are calling. If the last prime minister was worse than and this prime minister worse still, then we're remembering the last prime minister as better. We're rewriting history. We're not actually calling a spade a spade. We're not saying government is failing, but that is the problem.
Yep.
That right there is the problem. And that's why you see you have a portion of the quarters of Trinidad and Tobago that they don't like you, Philip. They don't like you because you're talking the truth.
Because I am sexy and they're jealous.
You're talking the truth.
I'm too sexy for this show.
You're
Tony, I have to not take them on.
No, you're stepping. You have to take them.
No, I cannot. And I tell all the PEP members, do not give them any validation. Let them talk the talk.
But we need to be aware of these individuals.
I measure my success by my haters and my detractors. And the more they ramp up, is the more I know I get any job done.
Correct.
Yeah, follow me close. Yeah. Follow me close. While they're mining, we business, we billing, we party.
Yeah, I agree.
Progressive Empowerment Party opened its second office in second anniversary. Come on. Yeah. Come on.
Fantastic. Round of applause.
Round of applause. Round of applause. Round of applause. Yeah. And Michelle Davis and that crew. I sat down there on that head table and I watched speaker after speaker come up to that microphone. I said, wow, look at the level. And these are our caretakers. Come now, man.
Yeah.
Come now, man. We ready already. We ready already. No, we don't have $300 million. No, we don't have 1% financiers. No, we're not part of the contract mafia. And we're going to still be washing car and barbecuing chicken. But we in this election to win it. And if Trinidad and Tobago wants a better country, they better get ready and stand up themselves.
Correct.
To all of you who are listening and calling today, we thank you very, very much.
Much love.
See you all on Wednesday at 9 o'clock right here. Stay safe, Trinidad and Tobago.
Stay safe, everybody.